you are with the best that I have left of the person I was 3 days back. And today I am someone different, going ahead, really going to accomplish my dreams. The one key lesson that I would be addressing upon from now on will be showing my story. Showing my story in a way that people really get inspired.
You're an absolute powerhouse. You can't help but listen to you. You demand the attention of the room. You're so congruent. I can see it in your eyes. I can see it in your heart that you believe in every single word that you say.
Today I know my story is important and story has everything. But it's just that I have to show it to them so that I'm able to inspire more lives around.
I would love to be a part of your journey in creating a one-man factory for your organization. It's always been in the back of my mind, you know, as a business entrepreneur, as sort of a CEO, communication is really key. It's how you communicate the message. It's not really what you say, but how you say it. And that has always been something that I've been aspiring to be better at. So let's join hands and do exactly that. Take your organization to the next level where it belongs. What I learned is the bag of tools. It's like I feel like empowered. I have a bag of tools that I can bring out depending on the audience, depending on the context, depending on what the message is. There's always a better way to share that story, to communicate that message. And that's really kind of what I took out of the bootcamp.
I can see this message here being on a TED stage. You know, you really are a thought leader in this space. And not only that, you've got all the experience, you've got the heart and the passion to actually want to make a difference. This is a core message that you need to take to the world.
I came here to bootcamp because I was an aspiring public speaker. Do you want to be successful?
Yes.
Great. You are in the right place. Do you know what my teachers, mentors, and gurus call me? Mr. Smart, Mr. Success. I'm not bragging about myself. I'm ever more grounded than ever because of the responsibility. Success is a responsibility. That's how I see it. And after coming here, what I learned was speaking is an art which can be learned over a period of time, and it's connected with emotions.
As an experienced Toastmaster, congratulations.
Thank you.
You know, one thing I really want to encourage you towards is there's nothing at all for you to prove. You've already achieved everything that you've achieved, which is just awesome. Continue on this journey towards what's possible for you being an influencer. I know that there's lots and lots of people that can learn and grow from you.
So when I go back from here, I'm going back as an influencer, thought leader, to influence the whole world.
I've been helping thousands of people over this past 12 years. But what I realize is that I have a deeper message to share with the world at large. To go to that world-class stage, I need to really fine-tune my skills much more. And in Sam, I saw that and make me ready for the world-class stage. How many of you think that lack of authentic communication causes problems in relationships? If we really want to have great relationships, if we want to really have great communication and impact on people, we all need to connect in to connect out. Whatever I have spent on this is worth the effort. And in fact, I feel that this should not just be for few individuals, it should spread to the masses, because all of us need it.
The joy and the smiley face that you have, you really do shine your light bright. Even though you have been shining your light a little bit in the past, this moment right now is the moment where you will be shining more brighter than any other time in history. People are now going to start knowing who you are. You're going to start getting recognized, because it's now time for you to rise outside of your circumstances, outside of the issues, outside of all your excuses, and shine bright so the whole world can see who you truly are and the difference that you can make.
Now I'm able to show those emotions, feel it inside me, and evoke the same emotions in the participants.
One of the most brilliant things which I learned is, in order to connect with the audience, how can you be vulnerable enough? How can you share that inside story of yours to connect? I have found that people who write down their goals have 90% chances of achieving their goals. I met up with Sam at the seminar, and I got highly mesmerized, highly energized by Sam's energy. But what I loved about him, when I reflected, saying that a person with just one hand has done such awesome wonders in life and taken his life to the next level, how can Solomon learn from him and come up to the brilliant stage out there?
Solomon, what we've seen in you is a real craft of you moving from one-to-one now more to one-to-me. I can see you on the big stages of the world. You are a keynoter. You can command the energy of the large stadiums of the world, and that's exactly where I can see you going.
The 3 days was tremendous amount of learning and an awesome experience. An experience where you get all the knowledge, all the skills, all the abilities, all the behaviors to transition your life from one level to the next level, from one orbit to the next orbit.
I wanted to be a more confident, more passionate speaker.
I just made 2 simple changes. It wasn't drastic. Anybody can do that. The first one, I made a conscious decision to go to bed a little bit earlier every night, just a little bit earlier. So a little less TV, a little less Facebook, and that would do it. The second and more important one, before getting into bed, I'll switch off my phone or put it on airplane mode. And I made a pact with myself that I won't touch it till I wake up in the morning. These 2 things tremendously changed my life.
I learned that public speaking is something that can be trained. And I found so many examples, so many friends that I've made, people who couldn't speak well before, but now they are fantastic. They are great on camera.
You're very clever. You're also very, very articulate. And when you're in an environment, you can just simply tell that, you know, that people are attracted to that clever, to that smartness about you, which is really, really great. One thing I love when you do get up on stage and when you do communicate, what you communicate is actually interesting. You don't put in any filler words. You back yourself very well, which is really, really great.
It's a lot more than just public speaking. I think this boot camp is transformational. It can change your life.
I'm here to learn a structure to be a speaker. If you have the will, you can develop your skills. My experience is it's a very, very beautiful structure, very easy and simplified for us to take it. And it was a great experience because by the end, you actually surprise yourself that you can do it. How do we start? I found there's one formula that always works. Be consistent. Be persistent. Be insistent. Usually when I talk, I never knew that words have gestures. So today when I'm talking, you know, my eyes can speak, my hands can speak, my body language can speak. This is something, a great takeaway. I've never seen a huge team supporting us. But Sam has definitely flown a lot of coaches, trained, supports for us. It was an amazing 3 days.
I think you're pregnant again with a new seed in your world. This seed is very soon going to give birth to a new chapter in your life. And this new chapter hasn't been written yet. But I can see that you are in this beautiful transition and the seed has been planted and you're pregnant with it. And you're going to give birth to a brand new world. And you're going to take this to a whole nother level. You know something? What you've already seen in the past, you ain't seen.
Everyone, can we please settle down? We are starting in a minute. Please, please.
Professional speaking is a profession.
May I request everyone to please take a seat?
Sam Cotton really drives that into you.
We've seen in you just in the last 3 days is that we've seen phenomenal growth, not only in your confidence, but also in the confidence of your story and your vulnerability. What we heard up here is someone that stood your ground no matter what life has thrown at you.
Yes.
You are a living, breathing embodiment of
Definitely.
Someone who is worthy
Yes.
to be followed, someone who is worthy to be a leader.
There are little nuances to some really big bang knowledge that he shares that has really helped me become not just a storyteller, but I intended to be an influencer, and that's exactly what this bootcamp has.
Can we all please settle down?
For everyone,
everyone please.
Who really want to not just share their story, but influence people. This is for the future influencers. You must do this bootcamp or you are out of the market. Our need to be safe, our need to validate a decision, to be anchored to safety is what is making us kill the dreams and passions of our own loved ones.
Everyone, please settle down, please.
Everything we now see is telling us a story, like the story of how I lost my arm. The story of products, services, brands, and organizations. The winners will be those who are showing the most powerful stories in the shortest possible time that evokes the most amount of emotion. The greatest leaders in the world are rapidly learning how to share more powerful stories to emotionally connect. This shows us that it's now time to stop telling the story. I am a story sheller. Watch this. I fell asleep. I veered over the other side of the road.
I'll give you an idea of the impact. The steering wheel of my car was underneath the passenger seat. My elbow was ripped from my arm, was 25 meters away from the car. I was told that I clinically died right there. My heart stopped for about 3.5 minutes. But I remember so clearly waking up from being on life support for an entire week. My entire family was right there by my bed. My mum, she looks at me like this and she goes, "Samuel, you naughty boy."
I don't tell to inform. I emotionally show to transform. We're about to see something that we have never seen before. Marketing will solely become stories. They will be shorter, sharper, faster, and easily catchable. Everything now is about the emotion. The next 3 years will shape the way we communicate in the next 30 years. We must stop telling and start showing at every touch point. This will evoke emotional connection. Now is the defining moment of our value proposition. It is up to us leaders to be at the forefront of global connectivity through sharing and showing more powerful stories to emotionally connect. It's time to show the story. The future of story is now.
Good morning, Delhi.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How's the Josh?
Hi.
Sirf yahan pe. How's the Josh?
Hi.
Okay. I want to thank you all for joining to our Speakers Institute one day event on story showing. That will help you to take your influence and persuasion skills to an entirely new level than it was before. So I'm so thankful that you have come out here and you all look so beautiful from here. Aap sab mere liye ek favor karoge? Please haan bolna yaar, pehla favor. Okay. Just look to your partner on right and left. Look into their eyes and say, "You look beautiful." Can we do that? Come on, let's do that. You look beautiful. Okay. Okay, before we go ahead, everyone, please out here. Before we go ahead, let me do some housekeeping announcements. We will have lunch break at 12:45 and we will end at 1:30. And the entire session is going to end before 5. ओके. एंड एक बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट अनाउंसमेंट मैं करना चाहूंगा. वी ऑल फॉलो ओके स्पीकर्स इंस्टीट्यूट, वी फॉलो IST विच इज इंडियन स्टैंडर्ड टाइम एंड नॉट इंडियन स्ट्रेचेबल टाइम. आर वी क्लियर विद दिस? ओके. माई नेम इज रूपक शाह. आई एम ए स्टूडेंट कम कोच कम फैसिलिटेटर विद स्पीकर्स इंस्टीट्यूट इंडिया. Now, what is Speakers Institute? You might be wondering. So, thank you for asking. Speakers Institute is an incubator for next generation influencers. Yes, we all want to be a big influencer. Who wants to be a big influencer out here in this room? Oh, awesome. We have been running boot camps in various major cities of Mumbai plus Delhi, Bangalore, all over India for over 6 years. Yes, and we believe that this will help you to take your influence and persuasion skills to an entirely new level and not what it is right now. Now, with all that question marks on your face, I know you're not here to listen to me. Yes, you're here to listen to the CEO and founder of Speakers Institute globally, Sam Cawthorn. He is international best-selling author of 2 books and written over 7 books. He has trained over 40 countries and shared stages like this, big stages, with people like Bill Clinton, Dalai Lama, Michael Jordan, and Richard Branson. This deserves a clap, right? Yeah. Oh! He is obsessed with creating change via story showing, and he has trained from TV celebrities to the highest paid speakers globally. He has been Edupreneur of the Year globally and Young Australian of the Year. Yes, this also deserves a clap. Come on! Awesome. Now, few personal things about him. He went to the same school as Ricky Ponting. Oh, cricket fans, come on! He's a father of 3 kids. And a husband of, my bad. Okay, husband of 1 wife. He resides in Sydney, Australia. Ladies and gentlemen, can we put all hands together for the Sam Cawthorn?
Much, Rupak, for that amazing introduction that I wrote. All right, how are you going? There are 2 things you need to realize about me. First thing is I do talk very, very fast, so make sure you keep up, okay?
Okay.
Second thing is I'm one of these type of, you know, motivational speakers, but I like interaction, participation. So if you hear something really awesome, really amazing, I want to encourage you. You know, you can clap, you can cheer, you can stand up on your chairs, throw me money. I would prefer the notes because the coins hurt. But first of all, I actually wanted to start with acknowledging you. Because you could have spending time on doing your to-do list. You could have spent your time, your valuable time, going out there and doing other things. But today and this morning, you've made a decision to spend a day with someone that you might not have even heard of before. So I wanted to, first of all, to start with saying thank you for being here. Do me a favor, turn to the person next to you and just say, for me, say thank you for being here. Come on, go, do it for me, yeah? Thank you for being here. You know... you guys did make a decision here today. And, you know, I love the word decision. The word decision comes from the Latin word desire, you know, incision. Scission. I believe the world lacks leaders that make decisions. Why? Because we love keeping our options open, don't we? We love sitting on the fence. But you've made a decision here today to spend a day with us, and we wanted to say thank you for that. So then that means then, in honor of the decision that you have made, my decision is that I want to make sure that I give you value here today. Do you get? Value is not value unless it addresses the pain point or problem of your target audience. I'll say that again. Value is not value unless it addresses the pain point or problem of your target audience. So the reality is this. I don't have value yet unless you tell me and share with me why you're here. So the very first part of today, I'm going to be, you know, asking you why you are here. Now, let me just frame a couple of things here. I want you to trust me that we know what we're doing. I've now spoken in over 40 countries. I've been on stage with some of the top tier presenters in the world. I've been in this industry space for over 13 years. I've been paid over $50,000. And so what's that? That's 25 lakh plus to do a 1 hour presentation. Now, I'm not sure if you understand how a professional speaker works, but let me give you an insight. For a professional, for me, it takes us 600 hours to develop a 1 hour keynote presentation. Now I'm talking 3 months full time to develop a 1 hour keynote presentation. We need to realize that our content, what we say, is the easy part. You know, how we frame our stories, the problem that we address, the ideas, the research, the data, the solution, the teachable framework, the content, that is the easy part. The methodology, how we say it, how we move our fingers, how we move our wrist, how we move our elbow, what do we do from the waist down and the waist up? Where do we put our shoulders? Where do we put our head? How is our facial muscles engaged in certain elements? Where do we put our eyes? What about our tonality? The pause before each word, the pause after each word. How do we end our sentences? This is orchestrated. We don't wing it. That is a disrespect to your audience. So I don't know if you've spent 600 hours on a 1 hour keynote presentation, but let me give you an insight here. Maybe there is another level that you can learn. Ticket. Now here at Speakers Institute, we've brought in the best in the world to help us build our curriculum and our programs here. We've brought in the best. Like, we're talking about Grinder, the founder of NLP. Not some practitioner, but the founder of NLP. Will bring him in to help us build our programs. We've brought in Alan Pease, the number one body language, yeah? He's written over 70 books. We bring him in to help us build our programs. We bring in the voice of Siri. Yes, that's a real voice. It's a real voice. We bring her in to help us build our programs. We are solid. We know what we're doing. I have over 3 years worth of content and programs here that I can deliver to you. But today, I only have a couple of hours. So I don't know. Actually, here, let me be really transparent with you here. Watch this. Ready? Watch this. These here are all my slides. Look at them all. Look at them all. Look at them all. Look at them all. Whoa, wait, how many? Look at them all. Look at them all. We have 148 slides that I have created just for today's program, but I only have enough time to show you 20, maybe 25. And I haven't decided what 25 you want until you tell me why you are here. You understand?
Yes.
And trust me when I say I know what I'm doing. So, why are you here? Wait. Put your hands down. What just happened? I just did this entire speech on the importance of you telling me why you're here. And then suddenly I then asked you to put your hand up to tell me why you're here. There was an uncomfortable silence. And then I saw one hand, two hands, and maybe 5% of hands, and that's it. Maybe I'm not making myself clear. Maybe you can't understand my English. I cannot help you. You will not get value from today unless you lean in and you participate. Do you understand?
Yes.
Great. So the last thing I want is for you to leave here and think, I didn't get what I thought I came for. You didn't get it because you didn't participate. You understand?
Yes.
I can't help you, and trust me, I know what I'm doing. And I know that you don't like wasting your time. I know that you didn't come here to think, I want to waste my time today. Isn't it?
Yes.
So you came here for a reason. I need you to participate today. I need you to lean in. I need you to put your hand up. I can't help you otherwise. I can't serve you. And if you thought that you were going to come along to another seminar where you can just observe and watch other people participate, then clearly you might be in the wrong room. You understand?
Yes.
So I would like to hear from you. I would like you to lean in. I would like you to participate. And that way I will acknowledge you. That way then you can then get value from today. Because again, I don't have value yet unless you share with me why you're here. You understand again?
Yes.
Great. So why are you here? Come on, this is where you put your hand up. Come on, everyone should be putting their hand up. Everyone. By the way, you are all very good looking. A lot better good looking than Mumbai that we did yesterday. All right, look, let's ask some of the front row here. We'll go with you. I'll get you to stand up. Share with us why you are here. And by the way, just to let everyone know, we had some people reach out to us and they said that they live with a disability and they physically couldn't come to this program here today. So we actually then asked our team to do a live feed. So just to let everyone know, if this is okay with you, we do have a live feed that's happening right now. So people online, I wanted to say hello to everyone. Actually, let's all turn around to the camera. Everyone just say hello. Hello to everyone online. Awesome. So yeah, I do have some people that physically couldn't be here for their disability. And so we do have live. So tell us, why are you here?
Good morning, friends.
Morning.
My name is Farhan and I have a fear of public speaking. And I want to overcome it, so that's why I'm here.
Okay, Faram. And this is a question to everyone here, Tike. Now, if there's one thing, just one thing that you wanted out of today, maybe that one thing is, hey, Sam, I need to learn how to make more money. I need to learn how to influence more people and get more people into my funnel because I know that I've got a commercial opportunity here. Or Sam, I'm losing people's attention and I don't know why. And I'm communicating, but people aren't listening to me. Or Sam, I need to learn exactly how to position myself in today's saturated market. Because Sam, I understand that there's more noise in my market and there's so many other people, and I want to learn how to stand out from the noise. Or Sam, I want to learn how to influence more. I want to learn how to grow a movement, how to get more people. If there's one thing that you wanted from today, just one thing, because I've only got a couple of hours with you, huh? Yeah. If there's one thing you wanted to get from me today, what would that one thing be?
I want to overcome with my fear, and I want to help others how to overcome it.
Very good. Give him a hand. Thank you. Thank you very much for coming on. You have come to the right place. Do me a favor. Turn to the person next to you and just say, you have come to the right place. Just do that. Yeah. Ah, yes, you have. Yes, you have. All right. Come on. Why else are you here? Why else are you here? I saw this lady here's hand go up first. I'll get you to stand up now. Just before she speaks, I want to tell you exactly what we are creating here today. So the reality is this. If you wait and you're not first to market, you will not be heard in the marketplace. If you wait and let others, let someone else get that space because you waited, if you let someone else get out there and get this, the saddest thing is that they don't know as much as you, isn't it? That these people here, but they were first to market because they didn't procrastinate. They were first to market, they took action, and then suddenly now they're being heard, everyone's following them, but they're not as good as you, but they were first to market. You understand? So today we are creating a real world scenario here today, ticket, which then means if you are first with your hand up, you will be heard. If you are not first with your hand up, you will not be heard. You understand?
Yes.
Great. Over here. Why are you here?
Hi, Sam. So I have a lot of public speaking engagements that I find myself inconsistent with the engagement in the audience. Sometimes I feel they are as passionate. I'm more passionate and they're able to engage with me and they connect to my story. Mm-hmm. And at other instances, I feel, oh, I lost them. And I know I've lost them. And then I see myself sinking further and I don't engage, you know, and then I was, okay, I've lost it already. And, you know, even if I have like an hour to go, I still feel I've lost it.
Yes.
And I mostly feel this pressure around when I know, okay, so recently we got our first project with a Fortune 500 company.
Congratulations.
Thank you. But I messed it up. So, and I could see that they're not engaging. And
yeah.
At that point, yes. I did this that, you know, I wanted to get their pain points, but I wasn't able to switch gear.
Yep, I get it. Let's give her a hand. That is great. Because you know what was really interesting, what we just saw here? As she was sharing, other people were nodding. And they're thinking, I am in the very similar boat, isn't it? You know, sometimes I might get an opportunity to speak or have a marketplace, and then suddenly I lose their attention. Or I lose that opportunity. Or I lose that sale. I can get in front of them, but then I lose it. And I get it. And so you'll certainly be looking at that. You know, one thing I... Thank you very much. One thing I found is this, is that our story, yes, it's easy to address problem and idea and evidence, etc., but we need to realize that story is our number one trump card. The moment that we start sharing stories, people lean in. Why do we love going to the movies? Why do we love reading novels? Because our story... Actually, get this ready. Whatever area of expertise that you have, whatever skill set that you have, I can find better online right now for free. Seriously, whatever skill set that you have, whatever area of expertise that you have, I can find better online right now for free. Your greatest trump card is not your area of expertise or your skill set. It's your story. No one in the world has your story. But what we do, we compare, isn't it? We say, oh, but Sam, your story is better than my story, isn't it? But Sam, you know, you are an international and you've only got one arm and your leg doesn't work. My story is boring and your story is better, isn't it? One of my students, his name is Paul. And this guy, Paul, he was diving in Sydney Harbour. Huh? This guy, Paul, he was diving and then he had a shark attack. This guy, Paul, had his arm and his leg bitten off by a shark. That's a better story than mine. Isn't it? I've just had a car accident. He's had a shark attack. But what we do, we compare, isn't it? We compare. We think their story is better than mine. Can I encourage you? It's not about the content, what you say. It's about the methodology, how you say it. One of my friends, he can turn an everyday journey down to the local supermarket and back to an edge of the seat thriller. Why? Because it is in the methodology, not the content. Whereas if you hear like, if you hear a very famous person who clearly should have a better story, they start speaking and in 2 minutes everyone's bored. It's not because of the content. Here's something else. If you want the best content in the world, go and be a university lecturer. Isn't it? If you want the best content, go and be a university lecturer. Because trust me, they will put you to sleep. Compared to a prof, and yes, they may have better content than me or more, yet at the same time, they do not get the 10 lakh rupees per hour to what I normally get. Isn't it?
Yes.
So my encouragement to you is learn the methodology. Not actually, here's something else here that you must realize. Ticket, watch this, ready? Your content, what you say, is only 20 to 30% of the influence and impact to the listener. Your content, what you say. Which then means that our methodology, how we say it, is up to 80% of the influence and impact to the listener. Now, for the trainers here in the room, for the presenters, for the people that do pitches, for the people that like basically talk to other people, the saddest thing is that where the majority of your preparation time goes, I would even say it's nearly 100% of your preparation time. Yet it's only 20 to 30% of the influence and impact of the listener. When was the last time you started focusing on what are my fingers doing? What is my wrist, my elbow? What's my facial muscles doing? What are my eye contact, my tonality, my pause? The subconscious modalities of nonverbal intelligence will influence anyone at all. And if you learn this, you will earn more money, period. If you learn this, you will have better sales. If you learn this, you will have better relationships. You must realize that your content, what you say, is only 20 to 30% of the influence and impact of the listener, which then means our methodology. Sam, how do we learn this then? What do we need to do? Let me share with you this. Let me tell you something you already know, huh? The results are in. The most important skill in the world is communication. We know this, isn't it? There's now data and research now that comes out that corporations are now saying that you can earn more money if you have presentation skills on your resume. Actually, KPMG recently released an article that said if you have presentation skills in your resume, you can earn over 15% more than anyone else in that same position as you. So then how can we upgrade the number one skill set on the planet? Do you know how we do it? We get quality feedback. Don't you dare go to someone that is not qualified to give you feedback, because your mum would love to give you feedback. Isn't it?
Yes.
The person next to you would love to give you feedback. Every person out there in the street would love to give you feedback. If you get the wrong feedback, which you have been doing, because today I'm going to teach you how to unlearn some things. If you get the wrong feedback, you will then need to unlearn it. So there are some elements today in story showing where I will need to teach you how to unlearn what other presentation trainers are teaching you. You will need to unlearn it. And I will explain very clearly why you need to do that. The only way to upgrade the number one skill set on the planet is by getting quality feedback. There's no other way. No other way. You cannot learn by sitting in a chair and observing someone else. You cannot learn by doing an online program. You cannot learn by reading a book. The only way to learn methodology is by getting quality feedback. There's no other way. You understand?
Yes.
Great. Why else are you here? Come on, come on, Wowsy. Oh, I saw your hand go up first. You have to be fast. You have to be fast. Give him a hand. Give him a hand. Come on, give him a hand. Give him a hand.
Thank you.
Why are you here?
Sam, my name's Ashish. I run a creative agency.
Huh.
And I'm obsessed with creative thinking, innovation. So I want to start a movement and influence people. So that's why I'm here. I want to learn how to influence people and how to create content around that.
So again, the essence of how to influence, is it more building your profile?
There is a lot of stories that I have with me that I would want to share with the world.
Yeah.
That's something that I want to bring out, and how we can do it is something that I want to learn.
Very good. Let's give him a hand. Give him a hand. Give him a hand. Get this ready. No, not yet, not yet. Ready? Catch this. Ready? You know what's really interesting? In my industry space, in many people's industry space here in the room, around 5.5 years ago, we saw one of the greatest transitions ever. 5.5 years ago, it was the first time in history that we saw the 100 most followed things online became human beings. You know, before that, we were following company brands, logos, products. We were following that. You know what we're now following? We're following people. People follow people. We know this. Let me tell you something you already know. People follow people, yeah? Just because you have the greatest product in the world, if I don't like you, I'm not going to take out my wallet. Isn't it?
Yes.
Which then means that, you know what it is today? It is the 1,000 most followed things online are human beings. People follow people. We know this, yeah? But you know what's really sad? What we do, right? We push our company brand and our company logo out there, which when we need to realize that our greatest visual marketing piece is this. It's your face! But too often, what we do, right, we push our logo out there in the marketplace. We push this out. We push it out. We push it out. We push it out. And then we hide behind the logo when we need to realize that our greatest visual value proposition is this. It's your face. People follow people. We're not following company brands, logos, products anymore. You know what your greatest piece of real estate is? You know what your greatest piece of real estate is? Get this. It's yourname.com. Not your company name. Not speakersinstitute.com. Not storyshowing.com. It's samcawthorne.com. People follow people. It is. Actually, here. Let me just do a survey here. Be honest with me. Ticker? How many people in this room own their own name URL? Not a company name. But your own name URL. High, hands up, nice and high, nice and high, nice and high. Look at that, 20% of the room, hands there you go. So watch this, ready? Watch this. For the other 80% that don't own their own name URL, at lunchtime today, you can do it. It'll take you 5 minutes. It'll cost you less than 1,000 rupees. You can do it at lunchtime. Now look, I know everyone's name here in the room. I do. You signed in, yeah? If in the next 24 hours you haven't bought your name, I'm going to buy it and I'll sell it to you. I'm an entrepreneur, yeah? Guys, I cannot encourage you. Go and buy your name URL. If I ask the person next to you right now and I said, I want you to Google your name. If I asked the person next to you to Google your name, what would come up? People follow people. And what we're seeing right now is 5.5 years ago, it was the 100 most followed things. Today, it is the 1,000 most followed things. You know, data and research is now telling us that in 3 years, it's going to be the 1,000,000 most followed things online of human beings. If you're not building your name as a profile in the marketplace, you're not pushing out your face out in the marketplace, then someone else is in your space. Guys, you have to catch this. You must catch what I'm saying. This is absolutely imperative for you today. Because if you do not take action on some of the things that I'm talking about here today, you will find you will miss the boat. And it will be sailing away without you. Who in this room wants to ensure that you are on that boat? Come on, who in this room? Great, you are in the right room here today. Very good. All right, do you have a question? Yeah, come on, let's give him a hand. He was good, he kept his hand up. Go.
Sam, I'm ideation team head at the Federation of Buying Agents.
Huh.
Buying agents are basically celebrities of the export industry.
Yeah.
I've been raising my hand for the 5 times when you said, and I noticed that you were not looking at this side of the audience. So I said, okay, I have to do something to catch his attention to look at this way also.
Dear, what's your question?
No, I was raising my hand to say why I'm here.
Why are you here?
Well, since my job as an ideation team had to influence the influencers. So, and I have a very good storytelling audience. They love what we are sharing with them. But then learning is always good. And that is why I'm here to learn extra. When you said story showing, it caught me. Thank you.
Very good. Give him a hand. The reality is this. If this gentleman here wanted to stand out, he cannot continue to say that he has very good storytelling. Because everyone in this room will say, I'm very good at storytelling. Everyone will. Isn't it? Which then means, I'm sure you do want to stand out in your marketplace to have a differentiating value proposition. Would you agree?
Yes.
Great. Which then means you can't just say you're a storyteller because everyone else is storytelling. Yes. Let me share with you something. Watch this. An average storyteller will inform. And that's where a lot of education stops. You know, teachers have been taught how to inform their students. Whereas a good storyteller will persuade. Salespeople have been taught how to persuade their customers and their clients. Isn't it? Whereas a great storyteller will inspire. Now, get this. I love inspiration. I go to the latest Marvel movie and I watch Captain Marvel. And I'm inspired through that. Inspiration will not necessarily lead to action. Isn't it? We can be inspired through something, but then we'll leave the room and we'll go back to our ordinary, everyday, busy lives. Which then means there needs to be a shift. And the shift first started 7 to 8 years ago. Catch this. 7 to 8 years ago, what we then saw is everyone started to talk about visual storytelling. We did, didn't we? Let's use more images. Let's use more video. Let's do more images and video. And let's do the visuals of story. Huh? But we were still talking about storytelling. Which then, today, what we're seeing internationally, there has to be even more of a shift. Let me ask you, because I believe it's in the terminology tell, yeah? If I say, let me tell you something, there's like a resilience against that. Why? Because we're sick and tired of people telling us what to do. We're at home and our parents tell us what to do. We're at school and our teachers tell us what to do. We're in the workplace and our boss tells us what to do. Now suddenly when someone comes up to us and says, let me tell you, there's a resilience against that terminology, isn't it?
Yes.
Let me ask you, if I say, huh?
It also sounds very condescending.
Yes, I'm only connecting with your head and I'm pushing you down. Let me tell you, I know better than, no you don't. It's scolding in a way. Here, get this ready. If I say, let me tell you something, compared to me saying, let me show you something, it lands totally different to the listener. I'm suddenly going from head to head, straight into heart to heart. Which then means this. An excellent story shower will transform. So what is transformation? Transformation means that I have been informed, I have been persuaded, I have been inspired, but now I'm ready to take action. That is what true transformation is. My hope today is that you will leave this room transformed, meaning that you've been informed, persuaded, inspired, but now you're taking action on what you have learned here today in today's program. That is my hope. You understand? I don't want to just inspire you. I don't want to just persuade you, and I don't want to just inform you. I want to transform you. However, this isn't the pinnacle. The pinnacle is what we like to call transcendence. And what transcendence is like an outer body experience. It's like a sense of timelessness. You want to stand out from the storytellers? Learn to transcend others people's thinking. You want to stand out from all the noise in your marketplace? Learn to transcend people when they have the opportunity to listen to you. You must learn how to transcend. And transcend is like an outer body experience. It's like a sense of timelessness. When someone is showing me something, I forget to look at my watch. I don't take out my phone and surf Instagram. Why? Because I am transcended in that moment. Who in this room would like to learn how to transcend other people's thinking? Come on, who in this room? Great, hands down, you are in the right room. You're in the right room here today because we haven't even started yet. But are you getting value so far?
Yes.
Great, I want to hear from two more people while you're here. I saw your hand go up first, gentlemen, in the red turban, thank you.
Yeah, my name is Manjeet, I'm the CEO of Paramount Group.
Huh.
I keep on getting appointments for the storytelling, and I do that as well.
Yeah.
And I believe, you know, they are kind of good ones. But I really want to make them legendary. That's the reason, you know, why I'm here.
Yeah.
Truly legendary.
Yep.
Nothing less than that.
Very good. Let's give him a hand. Let's give him a hand. We will certainly be unpacking this for you as well, because ultimately our attention spans today are very different to what they were even years ago. And let me give you some study. There was a Randstad study around 25, 30 years ago that showed that our attention spans were anywhere between 2 to 3 minutes. 5 to 6 years ago, there was another study that showed that our attention spans were anywhere between 7 to 9 seconds, shorter than a goldfish. Do you know what they are today? 3 seconds. 3 seconds. You know, social media, all social media platforms are giving marketers data on anyone at all that has viewed your post 3 seconds or more. Why? Scroll, 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 scroll. Our attention spans are 3 seconds. Now, don't get me wrong, long form media is still important because, you know, podcasts, you know, even Rogan's podcast is 90 minutes, but you have to get their attention first. You must understand how to grab their attention in 3 seconds or more or less. And we do that through show rather than tell. And I believe many of us in this room, you want to learn how to keep people's attention for a longer period of time. Is that correct?
Yes.
Great. And I'm telling you now, if you learn how to do this, you will make more money. You will. Because now you've got my attention. Now it's a lot easier for you to influence me. You can't influence me if you don't have my attention. And so we'll certainly be looking at that today as well, which is awesome. I want to hear just from one or two more people. Oh, you got to be fast. I did see your hand go up first. I'll get you to stand up. Thank you.
No? I have my voice. Hey, good morning, everyone.
Morning.
Yeah. Hi, Sam. So I'm here because I have been told all my life that I'm not very good at storytelling. And in my experience,
who told you that?
Of course, it's not qualified.
And you've listened to them.
I have, and it hasn't done me very well because out of confidence. Because when I started doing trainings, I wanted to do it. I was very passionate about it. I got good response, but I wasn't confident, and I wanted to become one better because this is something I'm passionate about. And also because, I want to shift like anyone sitting there in front of me.
I get it. You want to get them to take action on something.
Yes, absolutely.
100%, I get it.
I want it to be an experience. Okay. And yeah, so I want to know what I'm doing right and what I'm doing wrong.
Very good. Let's give her a hand. Very good. Very good. Give her a hand. You know, thank you. You know, the reality is the only way to know that if what you're doing right and what you're doing wrong is by getting quality feedback. That's it. There's actually no other way. You know, how we have orchestrated our boot camp events is that every single day you are speaking on stage and me personally, we give you feedback, including me. The only way for you to upgrade the number one skill set on the planet is by you getting quality feedback. There's no other way. You can't learn it through a computer screen. You can't learn it sitting in a chair. And what we're now seeing is phenomenal. You know, some of the people now that after getting feedback, the way that they've massively boosted their results, keeping their attention, getting people to action, it's been a total game changer. Yeah, and I'll tell you a little bit more about that today, but you certainly are in the right room here today. So look, there's a few other things that all throughout today, there will be opportunities for you to put your hand up and obviously interact with us and so on and so forth. There's a few housekeeping here. One housekeeping here is that I saw a couple of people taking photos here today. I don't mind you taking photos. Go for it, take photos. However, I would prefer no audio and no video at all today. Do we have an agreement here?
Yes.
Great. The second thing is that some of the elements in this program here today, you will find really easy to implement. You will find that, wow, this is really easy to catch, and that's the way how a lot of our programs are actually created and designed, yeah? Which then means this, I want you to write notes. There was a reason why we put a pen and paper on your chairs. I want you to learn as much as you can in this room. Why? So then you can go out there and you can implement it. You can go and make a difference. And so I would like for you to take what you caught here today and go and implement it. Go and make more of a difference. Go and make more money. However, if you are a trainer here today and you came to steal content, then you're completely out of integrity and you shouldn't be here.
You're in the wrong room.
So my encouragement to you is, learn this and go out and do it, but you can't train it. You can't teach this. You can't then buy content as your own. You can't do that. You're completely out. Integrity. So it's really important that we do have this agreement. Use this stuff. Go and take this and go and use it and go and make a difference. But you can't teach this stuff. Do we have an agreement here?
Yes.
Great. Awesome. You are in the right room then. All right. So I now want to invite my team to come up here on stage. And my team are basically here to serve you guys. These guys here, this event would not have been possible. Because clearly, you know, I travel all around the world, and so these guys here are obviously hosting me being here. And so I'm now going to invite my team to come up and obviously share a little bit more about who they are, what they do, but also how they can serve you here today. So come on, ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together for our amazing team. Come on, put your hands together for them. Line up in a line here. Do we have a microphone? Did you guys bring the mic? Yes, you got the mic. Awesome.
Hello everyone, my name is Karthik, I'm an engineer turned psychologist. I have been friends with Sam since 8 years, and I happened to do my boot camp in a phase of my transition, and that was one of the best decisions, and rest is history. So at that time I didn't even know what a boot camp was, but I knew that Sam was coming to India through his Facebook post. And I just went to meet him there, and I signed up for the bootcamp without having a shred of an idea what it was, because I knew that anything he would do would be my money. So yes, that's how I started on this journey, and it's been great so far. Thank you.
Hi everybody, I'm Ruchi. Hi, that's a nice response. Okay. So I am the Programs Manager of Speakers Institute India. In fact, for you, I am Speakers Institute India. And I have got Sam Cawthorn here for you today.
Yeah. Give a round of applause. Woo!
Thank you.
Come on. Woo! Hey.
I'm also a speaker agent. I sell speakers globally. Like, I get you work if you're a speaker. Yeah, that's what I do. Yeah, that's about it. Let's connect, you know. Thank you.
Hello, once again. My name is Rupak Shah. By qualification, I completed aircraft maintenance engineering. And as people in India say, you realize what you want to do in life after you complete engineering. So that is where the transition happened. I met Sam at that time, did his boot camp. Now, I started at a young age of 22, and there is always a curiosity or always a fear that people will accept me as a trainer. Right now, I train close to 10,000 plus people, including a session at Antilia. Any idea what is Antilia? Mukesh Ambani's house. And so one of the things which Sam teaches us a lot is be faithful with small so that big will follow. Okay? So in that way, we also started to create videos, no idea why will people see me. And one of the video last week, what we did on LinkedIn, got more than 1.5 lakh views, everything organic. So that's it from my side. Would love to connect to you more during break another time. Thank you so much.
Very good morning. My name is JP Singh. By profession, I'm also an engineer. So, by profession, I'm a solar consultant, helping people to grow money from the solar and contributing to the environment. That's my passion. I also feel like bringing sun closer to you, making a smile on your face. We got in touch with Sam Cawthon, and we really love the concept of Speaker Tribe, and one of our driving force, Ashutosh Khan, who has been after Sam for opening Speaker Tribe Delhi chapter. And we launched that chapter on 16th of Feb, and we as a part of team Chibbar Saab, Ashutosh Khan, Deepak Mittal, the chapter was launched on 16th of Feb, and we really thank Ruchi and Sam for giving us this opportunity to open this chapter in Delhi and helping the people of Delhi to practice story showing in their life.
Yeah! Woo!
Rupak shared a beautiful thing about the video. I only want to share one thing. I recently made a video, and that video got 1,000 views. And that 1,000 views is a very big thing for me. So I am really experiencing the power of videos. The rest of the things will be shared by Ashutosh Kant, driving force behind Delhi Speaker Tribe.
Thank you, everyone. Can we have a huge round of applause? Let's have some energy. Trust me, it takes guts to be on this stage. It actually takes a lot of guts. Though my now the legs don't shake, it's been a very, very recent journey for me to be on the stage, because I found that my passion is to be on stage and to inspire and to influence. And when I met Sam around 6 months back, again in the similar room, right, I was inspired. And that day I thought that whenever he's going to have this event, I'm going to be in the stage. Because, and I am here, I manifested it, I'm here. And the kind of work Sam is doing, you know, he's the greatest story shower right now in the world. And I would love to be trained by him in his boot camps. You know, there's a boot camp which he trains people, and I would love to be part of it. Because see my journey, from being no one to being on stage to being able to influence so many people here to come, you know, thanks a lot. Thanks a lot. It means a lot to me. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.
Hi, everyone. This is Deepak Mittal. I'm an engineer. Ashu is also an engineer. So there are a lot of engineers on the stage.
As mechanical engineers.
Me too. Mechanical and into computer lines. So again, transformation, transition, whatever you can say. As Ashutosh was telling, that it is really a lot if you are standing on the stage. And right now, yes, right, my legs are trembling because this is the first time I'm standing on the stage. And
wow, come on, woohoo, hey.
And definitely, if it is the first time, next time also I'll be here. And Sam is there to probably train us all.
Come on.
And we'll be learning a lot out of him. Thank you so much.
Yeah, come on.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
My name is Vivek Chhibber, and I am not an engineer. So I'm a trainer, I'm a coach. I coach people in the area of money. And Speakers Institute, thank you so much for enlightening me, bringing me to this platform, and also for starting Speakers Tribe here in Delhi. So thank you so much.
Yeah.
A big thank you for all of you for being here and encouraging Speaker Tribe Delhi. Big round of applause for all of you.
Hey, just before you guys leave the stage, we actually do have a couple of special things that we're going to be doing here. Ashutosh, should I get you to stand up here on stage? I absolutely love being a part of a proximity. You know, the second chapter of one of my books is called Proximity is Power, which basically means there is undisputed evidence that now shows that you are the average of your five closest friends. The company that you keep determine who you are. Would you agree?
Yes.
Absolutely. So these guys here obviously have been in our proximity, and we thank you guys so much. But also, Ashutosh here, he is actually, by being in the proximity, he is just about to launch his book. Actually, he's going to launch his book right now. So, hey, tell us a little bit more about the book. Can we give him the mic? Tell us more about the book, Ashutosh.
Look, we are into software consultancy. And we were looking at, you know, and one of our products is for clubs. We automate clubs. So we thought, you know, what is the best way to... So every club has a story to show, right? So we thought, you know, what is the best way to influence people and how to get them? So we wrote a book on clubs, and it's called Club 3.0. It is the future, something like Alexa, right? We have Alexa in a household. It's an AI. So we thought we're going to do something for the clubs across India. And trust me, when we talk about clubs, you know, it's a complete universe in itself. The people, the entrepreneurs, so much business, so many things, and they require a story shower. So we thought, you know, so with the inspiration we got from Sam, I've been privileged, honored, you know, to have my book being, you know, unveiled by the greatest story shower. Thank you, universe. Thank you, Sam. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Here, can someone here? Come forward. Come forward. Take a photo. Come forward.
Come
forward. Take a photo.
Come on, Deepak. And me and Deepak have co-written this book. Two engineers and MBAs.
And mechanical engineers. Mind it.
Very good, very good.
Thank
very
you.
Good.
Thank you.
Come on, let's give these guys another round of applause. Thank you. Thank you very much. Awesome. Awesome. As you can see, we only like choosing good-looking people. Yeah. Half engineers. I'm not an engineer either, by the way. All right. So what I want to do, first of all, I want to start with sharing with you a little bit more about my story and my personal story. And mainly because you can actually see I've got dark skin. It's actually because my mum, she was born here in India. She was born in Kharagpur, which is just out of Kolkata, there in West Bengal. So she's Bengali. Balawachi, yeah. And so my father, he was born in Scotland, in Edinburgh in Scotland. Now, my dad, he was doing prac because he's a horticulturalist, and he was there in Kharagpur, and he was helping a lot of the farmers there. And now, this is back in the late 50s. And so my mum's parents, they'd actually chosen all these husbands and all these partners through an arranged marriage, but my mum, she fell in love with this white boy in the village. And through my mum's, you know, real disassociation with their parents and dishonouring, my mum then decided not to listen to her parents, but decided to marry this white boy. And so my older sister, she was born there in Kolkata, and then my mum and dad, then they migrated through to Australia. So I was born and raised in Australia. My mum didn't teach me much at all about my Indian heritage, and I still have an incomplete about that. But however, I do love my Indian curries. But everything underneath my skin, I was born and raised in Australia. I'm an Australian. However, 10 years ago, for the very first time in my life, I came through here to India. And I completely fell in love with the country. And ever since then, I've now been back here to India a minimum of 2 to 4 times every single year. And it's mainly because I was doing some charity work with kids that live with a disability in the slum areas. And then from there, we launched our business. And then I suppose the rest is history. And we absolutely love being as part of our Speakers Institute here in India. We now have many facilitators and many trainers that we send into IBM and Canon and BMW and ICICI and so on and so forth. Some of our partners that we do have here with Speakers Institute India are actually quite phenomenal. So we work with many TEDx events all throughout the country, as well as also do some big things with IBM and so on and so forth. We launched Speakers Institute at Google headquarters. So one thing that I've done, I know exactly how to build networks with Fortune 500 companies very well, and obviously that's what we do with a lot of our trainers. So if you'll decide to join boot camp today, and then through that, if we like you, we'll then train you to be one of our trainers that we then send into corporations, etc. So again, proximity is power. So let me share with you a little bit more about my childhood, because I think I've actually do have a disclaimer here for you this morning, and you may even judge me for this, but hear me out. I was a very shy kid at school, and I did not like being, you know, standing up in front of school, because I felt very insecure inside. All I wanted to feel was acceptance. So I started hanging around with the very naughty kids, because I felt acceptance with these naughty boys. And then suddenly then, I found myself doing things that I knew I should not have been doing, and I got kicked out of school. So here is my disclaimer. I have never sat an exam before in my life. Wait, you clap. Well, wait, I haven't finished. I've never been to college. I certainly have not studied at university. Actually, I failed English, but I've written 7 books, including 2 New York Times bestsellers. Well, I never studied at university, yet I've spoken in 15 different universities, including Harvard University. And I share this with you to prove a point, is that I always knew deep down within that there was something more. Actually, one more disclaimer is this, is my parents, they were very poor. Like, I'm talking very poor. My parents never owned land. They never owned a new car. They never owned a house. We grew up in very lower socioeconomic area there in Tasmania, which is the little island under mainland Australia. I grew up in a very poor, lower socioeconomic area. But I knew deep down within, in my core, that there was something more. That even though traditional education wasn't for me, I still realize deep down within that there is a calling on my life to go out there and make a difference in the world. Hands up in this room who has felt that calling. Come on, hands up. Great. So that's exactly what I knew and I felt. But then I was very uneducated. And so I got a job at Pizza Hut. And I started working a little, and then in the job that I had, they gave me a big company car. Now, I don't know if you've ever been to Australia, but in Australia, they have long, straight, open roads. And sometimes you will drive up to 100 kilometers without a single bend, and also without a single car. Isn't it? So if you've ever been driven in Australia, these are some of the roads that you will find. And so one day, I was driving along in my company car, and there was no other traffic, and so I put my car into cruise control. and I drove along and I fell asleep when I was driving. I veered over the other side of the road, and then a big truck came up, and the police said it was a 206-kilometre head-on collision with a semi-trailer truck. I'll give you an idea of the impact. The steering wheel was underneath the passenger seat. My arm was ripped from my elbow was ripped from my arm. It was 25 meters away from the car. I was in a coma for an entire week, in hospital for 5 months, and then in a wheelchair for an entire year. Doctors said I would never be able to walk ever again. I'll be in a wheelchair for the rest of my life. You know when the doctors say that you can't do something? And you just want to prove them wrong, isn't it?
Yes.
Absolutely. And when I pulled myself up out of that wheelchair after 12 months, I knew that there was even something more. I knew that I was literally raised from the dead for a reason and a purpose. Now, after my car accident, I started to share my story. And so here I am, I'm sharing my story into schools and into youth groups and so on and so forth. And I thought, wait a sec, maybe I could start charging to share my story. So I started to charge. It was around 20,000 rupees in Australian dollars, but 20,000 rupees to go and share my story into schools. Because I realized that from every school that I was speaking at, there was another school that was booking me, another school that was booking me, another school. Now, on a side note, for the trainers here in the room and the people that do presentations, if you're not getting 3 to 5 speaking engagements on the back of every engagement that you're doing, you're still doing something wrong on stage. You understand?
Yes.
Which then means that when I first started my presentation, I had no website, I had no online presence, I was just very good on stage. Which then meant that if I was good, then other people there... can we get the sound guys to have a look at this, if you don't mind? Thank you, Karthik. Which then means that if I'm then on stage, every single gig that I was doing, they were saying, he is amazing, let's book him again, let's book him again. Because I've heard it all before. But Sam, they said I was the best speaker they ever had. And I hear people always come to me and they say, hey, how do I get more speaking engagements? How do I get more paid speaking engagements? How can I get more international speaking engagements? And the very first thing that I say is, don't upgrade your marketing material. Don't upgrade your website. Just get good on stage. Because clearly they're not rebooking you. You know, so get this. And this is the difference, ready? Let's say you go and speak, and then they will come up to you, and they will say, thank you so much. You are an excellent speaker. You are one of the best speakers we've had. Thank you so much. See you later. But what happens to me? This is what they say to me. They say, thank you so much. That was the best. That was awesome. It was exactly what we need. Now, we have another 3 more events. Can we lock you in for those events? Plus also, we have our larger sister company. They have their big annual conference. Let's book you into that as well. Plus also, we've got another company over. We want you to speak for that. Plus also, my brothers, cousins, aunties, sisters, nephews, dogs, butchers, wives, sister is an event manager. Let her book you as well. If you're not getting 3 to 5 speaking engagements on the back of every gig that you're doing, you are still doing something wrong on stage. How do I know? Because you're not getting rebooked. How do you get rebooked? You get solid quality feedback. There's no other way. When was the last time someone gave you feedback on your methodology? When was the last time, like, you got paid 10 lakh for a 1 hour keynote presentation? There is another level, and you do not need to be a celebrity. You do not, because the celebrities get a lot more than that. But the average for a one-hour keynote in this country is a lot more than what you might think. Let me give you a reality check. Ready? Just here in Delhi alone, just here in Delhi, there is about 600 to 700 conference venues. At every single one of these conference venues, there is one event minimum every day. Minimum. 60% of these conferences require a paid speaker to speak on that stage. So right now, we have about 400 plus people just in Delhi alone, which are getting paid to speak on stage today. And clearly it's not you. There is another level. And when you get solid feedback, it actually, look, I haven't always been like this. I remember, get this, I remember my very first ever corporate gig. It was from one of the major banks. It was similar size to ICR, big, big, big bank, yeah? But it was in Australia, Commonwealth Bank. And I remember, you know, I was charging a lot of money for this event. I think I was charging about 4 lakh. So it was a high paid speaking engagement. And I thought I was excellent. It was my very first corporate gig. I was doing a lot of schools, and now I'm doing corporate. I am very, very good. That's what I was telling myself. So I remember I went to the Hobart International Airport, and they flew me up through to the Gold Coast, and I flew business class, and someone that was there in the Gold Coast Airport, they had my name, and they carried my bags through to a stretch limousine. And then here I am in a stretch limousine. They drove me to the Palazzo Versace. Here I am at the Palazzo Versace. There's like 800 of these high performers that were there. And here I am, like I'm about to speak, and the MC gets up on stage. Now, I don't know about you guys, maybe it's just me, but I was like standing up there towards the back when the previous speaker was speaking. And I was like judging this speaker. I was saying, oh, look at him. He's got too red, like he's too much energy. He's not telling his stories good enough. Look what he's wearing. I was judging this speaker before. Maybe you don't do that. Maybe it is just me. So the MC then gets up on stage and then share and then introduces me. And now I walk from the side and I get up on stage and then I start sharing my presentation. I had been paid for a one-hour presentation. Now, I thought I was excellent, but I was very nervous. Now, what happens when you're nervous? Your palms start to sweat, your heart starts to beat really fast, you get all that adrenaline all the way through your body, and then through that, you start speaking a lot faster than what you had prepared for. So I delivered my one-hour keynote presentation, and I looked up at the clock up at the wall, and it was only 20 minutes in. Now I had no other content. I had nothing. Actually, on a side note, my encouragement to always have twice as much, if not three times as much content as you have prepared. Why? Because there's now been 7 times in my professional speaking career where the event manager will come up and they'll say, hey, Sam, our next speaker, they've missed their flight. They're sick. They're unwell. Their family tragedy. Something. Would you be ready to do a second keynote for us? And nowadays, I say, absolutely. I was born ready. But that time up there in the Gold Coast at the Palazzo Versace, I had nothing else. Now, 3 months beforehand, I went to a Tony Robbins seminar. And so I started to say all these Tony Robbins messages and these Tony Robbins quotes, which was irrelevant to my message. And so in my audience, I was doing a verbal vomit. Yeah. And so then I had nothing else. I had nothing. And then I looked up at the clock up at the wall and it was only another 20 minutes in. So now we're at 40 minutes and I had nothing else. So I thanked my audience and I walked off stage. And the audience were looking at me and they were going, oh, with a like half-hearted clap like this. And the event manager ran from the back of the room. She comes to the side of stage and she goes, Sam, is this some type of joke? And I said, no. And then, in not as many words, she said, that wasn't quite what we expected. We will never book you again. Now, I was devastated because I thought I was the next best thing, but I wasn't that good. And so with my head down, flying back down to Tasmania, I'm thinking to myself, I'm not good enough. I'm not worthy. Who am I? The only, like, I grew up in a poor society. My parents don't own anything. I'm uneducated. I haven't sat an exam. I haven't been to school. On top of that, I'm disabled. What is your excuse? Because this is my excuse. This was my excuse. I'm not good enough. I'm not worthy. I am a nobody. All I've had is just a car accident. That's all. And I remember, I then remember getting back home to Tasmania, and my wife was there. And my wife is actually online live right now. So I wanted to say hello, Kate, my beautiful darling. And my wife, she really believed in me. And then right there, guys, my wife and I, we made a decision to cut off and kill every option, because I thought that I couldn't do this. But we made a decision. And the decision was this, that I would need to spend a lot of money, a lot of rupees, on my brain, on my education, on my personal development. If I wanted to learn this, I needed to invest in myself. Why? Because I wanted a return on investment, isn't it? Yes, yes. So get this. Over the next 18 months to 2 years, and since I then started, I have now spent more than 2 crore on myself in personal development. 2 crore rupees. So get this. After 2 years, after I started this, I then was asked to be the closing keynote speaker for the International Federation of Professional Speaking annual conference. Now, imagine this, right? Imagine a room of 2,000 professional speakers. Imagine the larger-than-life egos, personalities, and little old me from Tasmania, who no one knew, I was asked to be the closing keynote. And so we saw all these other speakers, they were presenting, etc. And then right at the end, the MC gets up on stage and they introduce me, and I get up on stage, and then I start then delivering my 1 hour keynote presentation. Like, this is where Tony Robbins is on the front seat. And I deliver my 1 hour keynote presentation, and get this. I had 3 standing ovations and was the highest ranked speaker in the history of their annual conference. Wow. So I'm sharing this story with you to prove a point. I was not born with the gift of the gab. I was not born as a professional speaker. Most people think, oh, look, Sam, you were born like that. No, I wasn't. This is a skill. And it can be learnt. I was a shy kid at school. I didn't like standing out. I didn't know how to communicate. I didn't know how to speak. But I invested in myself and I learnt this craft. I spent over 2 crore rupees on me in order for you to see, in order to upgrade this. Who in this room needs to upgrade this? Come on, who in this room wants to upgrade it? Absolutely we do. And so let me share with you a little bit more how I did that. But just before I do, what I'd like to first of all start off with is I want to find out who we have here in the room. And that way then I can frame some of this program that's going to be relevant for you. Ticker? So I'm going to put 5 positions up here on the screen. The titles, and in most cases, one of them will explain who you are. And so I'm going to show them all here to you up on the screen, and then I'm going to explain what they all are. And then I'd like for you to put your hand up only once in one of these areas, one of these categories. However, I want you to think of you in the next 6 to 18 months. So it might not necessarily be you today. But in 6 to 18 months, that's where you would like to be. You understand?
Yes.
Great. So these here are the five positions. So you've got corporate entrepreneur, thought leader, consultant, professional speaker, business entrepreneur, and expert authority. Let me unpack them all for you. So the first one there is a corporate entrepreneur. This person is an employee. However, they are an influencer within that organization. They may be a manager, a leader, climbing that corporate ladder. They might want to be CEO or executive, or they could be an in-house trainer that obviously is influencing within that organization. So the bottom line is this: you get a paycheck and you are an employee, you have a boss. So that is a corporate entrepreneur. When I was working for Pizza Hut, I was an employee entrepreneur. You understand?
Yes.
Tigger. The next one here is a thought leader consultant. So as a thought leader consultant, you run what we call a practice. Now, what a practice is that you do both one-to-one and also one-to-many. One-to-one, you might want to tell them your thoughts and your advice, or you write a book. One-to-one, you might be a really good questioner, so then you are a coach. One-to-one, you might be really showing people what to do, so then you are a mentor. Yeah? And then you got one-to-many. So one-to-many, you might be telling people your thoughts and your ideas, so you're a keynoter. One-to-many, you might be asking the people what to do, asking people questions, then you're a facilitator. One-to-many, you might be actually showing them your program, which then means you are a trainer. So a thought leader consultant runs a practice. You do both one-to-one, but also you do one-to-many. One-to-one, you write a book, you're a coach, you're a mentor. One-to-many, you're a speaker, you're a trainer, you're a facilitator. You understand?
Yes.
So that there is what a thought leader practice does, yeah? The next one is this, is a professional speaker. Now this is interesting. And by the way, if you're not writing this down, I would be encouraging you to write this down, yeah? Now, with professional speaking, there is something that I'm actually about to create an aha moment for you, because not a lot of people are about to know what I'm about to say. Did you know that there is a difference between professional speaking and public speaking? Are you sure you know? Because there is a very difference, and you can't do both. You can't do both. There is a massive difference between professional speaking and public speaking. Would you like to know the difference?
Yes!
Okay, so the difference here is this. A professional speaker, we get paid to speak on stage in a closed room events. Let me give you an example. BMW put on a conference for BMW employees. This isn't open to the public. This is a closed room event. So they get a professional speaker to speak in that closed room event only for BMW employees. IBM put on a conference for IBM employees, a closed room event. It's not open to the public. So then a professional speaker to go and speak at that. So this is a keynote. Google will put on a conference for Google employees in a closed room event, not open to my, so get this. For 13 years, I've been a professional speaker. My brother wanted to come and see me speak, and he couldn't see me speak for up to 2 years. And even though I was speaking 3 to 5 times every week, why? Because all of my gigs were closed room events. It wasn't open to the public. So that's professional speaking. Now over here is public speaking. Now, public speaking, clearly they're in the public eye, so we know who they are. Tony Robbins is a public speaker, not a professional speaker. T. Harv Eker is a public speaker, not a professional speaker. Brian Tracy is a public speaker, not a professional speaker. Robert Kiyosaki is a public speaker. Jack Canfield is a public... These are public speakers, not professional speakers. There's a difference. Huh? Who?
Robin Sharma.
Oh, no, he's a local guy, yeah? Oh, Robin Sharma.
Yeah.
Hear me out. I'm going to unpack them yet. I actually haven't unpacked them. So then you may be able to place him in the category when I finish explaining it. Yeah? Do you get? So let's just say hypothetically that there are good things and bad things for both the professional speaking and good things and bad things, let's say, for public speaking. Let's call them balconies and basements. Let's look at a balcony for professional speaking. So the reality is, in my world, I will get paid to speak on stage. There's no back end. I cannot sell a product. I can't sell my website. Can't sell my book. I can't sell my program or anything at all like that. The organization has paid me a specific fee to go in and deliver my message. There's no back end or anything at all like that. So we got paid top dollar to speak. So I've now spoken, you know, all around the world, constantly, you know, 40 plus countries, etc. So as a professional speaker. Now the good news, so the balcony level of this is that, yeah, I get to travel around the world and I only travel business class. I get to share the stage with, you know, the likes of President Bill Clinton, Dalai Lama, you know, some amazing people. On top of that, I get to, you know, speak on stage in front of tens of thousands of people week in, week out. And on top of that, I'm just a solopreneur, which means I have one or two support staff, but that's it. Why? Because I just simply speak. There's no back end, there's no program or anything at all like that. However, let's look at basement levels. If I don't speak, I don't get paid. There's no residual. There's no back end. If I don't speak, I don't get paid. Which then means that I'm going to miss out my kid's birthday, my son's soccer match, my daughter's ballet lessons. Why? Because if I don't speak, I don't get paid. On top of that, this audience, they're not my audience. I'm borrowing that audience from that client. So they will tell me what I can speak on, what I can't speak on. They will tell me when I can speak. They will tell me how long I can speak for. I don't get to decide that. They do. So I'm borrowing that audience. So they're the good things and bad things, yeah? Let's have a look at over here, public speaking. The balcony level of public speaking is, yes, I actually get, it's like, get this, this here is my room, which then means I can speak in this room for whatever I want, whatever I long, however long I want. I can also determine what the days are. No one else can, I do, yeah? On top of that, you guys are my audience, which then means I can truly transform your life. I can work with you very closely, and get this, nowadays I get so much joy when I walk through any airport in the world. And I walk through the airport. You know the bookshops at airports. You know the bookshelves, yeah? So when I walk past a bookshop in an airport anywhere around the world, this is what I see. Our student's book, 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 our student's book. We are the incubator for the next generation of influencers around the world. Recently, I was at the airport in New York City, and I found 10 of our students' book there on the bookshelf all around the world. I'm telling you now, you have come to the right place, because what we do, we are very good at what we do.
So how come you haven't listed public speaking there? You mentioned
professional. Wait, I haven't even started on the basement left. Just hear me out. Hey, by the way, if you want to speak, can I actually get you to put your hand up? That way I will acknowledge you, and that way then you can speak. Because otherwise, if everyone just spoke out of the willy-nilly, it'll be chaos in here. I'm sure we don't want chaos.
Yes.
Yeah? So if you do want to speak, just put your hand. Is that okay? Cool? Great. So that way then you can put your hand up. That way I acknowledge you, etc. So the balcony level of public speaking, should I say, is that, we put on events. Now, some of these events can either be a free event or a small paid event. And basically what we do, we give a lot of value. And then we then say, if you've loved today, here's our program. Would you like to buy it? Would you like to invest in it? So that's what a public speaker will do. And now we've got the basement level of public speaking. If you don't know how to sell, you don't get paid. Simple as that. So if you still have this icky feeling of sales and marketing, this icky feeling that I have to ask for the sale, this icky feeling of, you know, of talking about money, this icky feeling of, so then it's not going to work over here. So at basement level, you need to be willing to sell. You need to be willing to pitch. You need to be willing to go over the top and obviously selling how good your products and your programs are. Now, another basement level is this. There are a lot of sharks that come in, and sometimes, you know, they give a little bit of a bad taste in this industry, etc. But in most cases, you need to be willing how to sell. So the bottom line is this. Today, this event, through popular demand, I am putting on my public speaker hat. Which basically means, yes, the last 30 minutes today, I will be pitching our boot camp. Of course I will be. It's a public event. Of course. So there are good things and there are balconies and basements to both professional speaking, balconies and basements to both public speaking. Now, the point being is this. If you haven't built your profile, you can't do both. If you've built your profile, then absolutely you can do both. Not a lot of people in the world that can do both. Why? Because over here, if you think about it, I'm charging 10 lakh rupee for me to speak. And over here, how much did you pay to be in this room? 1,000 rupee? Then how is that possible? How is that fair in the marketplace? It's not fair. So the reality is this, is that it's not until such time as you build your profile when you can do both. If you haven't do profile, you can only choose one. You understand?
Yes.
Great. So then that there's professional speaking. The next one here is business entrepreneur. As a business entrepreneur, you have a product or a services that you deliver out there in the marketplace. So in most cases, as a public speaker, you are a business entrepreneur. A professional speaker, you've got a separate category there. But a public speaker, yes, you are a business entrepreneur. So today, I will put my hand up here because this is going to be my main focus over the next few years. I have services which I will be delivering out there in the marketplace, of course. However, you will still need to build your profile though. Why? Because people follow people, of course. If I don't like, I'm not going to take out my wallet, yeah? And so that is a business entrepreneur. Now, the last one here, I want to spend a little bit of time on this last one because I think this one here is really, really important. And I'm going to show you a diagram. I don't even have a flyer for this or a slide for this. So I'm going to show you exactly what I need to do here, right? So when I first started out, I was a bit of an inspirational speaker, right? So basically what that meant, I was in the inspirational category. He's got an inspiring story. I just simply went out there and shared my story. So I've been a top tier storyteller back in the day when I was just simply sharing my story. But then I needed to differentiate myself from everyone else in my marketplace. Guys, you know that in your industry right now, there is more noise in your space than any other time in history. You need to learn how to differentiate yourself and stand out from your marketplace. Would you agree?
Yes.
Great. So then that means then what I then needed to do, I needed to then differentiate myself. And this is where I became a bit of an expert, right? And so what an expert is that actually one of my mates, his name is Brendan Burchard, and he started Experts Academy. But basically what we teach you in order to become an expert, catch this, ready? You go into Amazon, you buy the 10 of the best-selling books, and you read them all. And then you go into TED.com and you watch what other people in your same industry space is actually speaking about. So you immerse yourself in what other people are saying. And then on top of that, then you find other experts and then you interview them. You know what that's called? It's called borrowed credibility. So what that means is that you are associating yourself with these other experts and then you're interviewing them. Suddenly now you're elevating your position in the marketplace. I'll give you a great example of what borrowed credibility is, yeah? So this here is basically borrowed credibility. So I'm using the credibility of other logos that you recognize around the outside in association with Speakers Institute, yeah? It's called borrowed credibility. So I'm using the credibility of these other people. So let's go back here, right? So you've read the 10 of the best-selling books in your industry space. You go into TED and you watch what other people are saying. On top of that, you go on... You go online, find other experts, and you interview them to elevate your borrowed credibility, yeah? So yeah, now you've become a bit of an expert in your field. But then you'll realize there's more experts today than any other time in history. It's no longer good enough for you to just simply be another expert, which then means we need to differentiate ourselves even more. This is where we become what we like to call a thought leader, yeah? So we spoke about thought leadership earlier on, but the reality is what a thought leader does is that they get paid for how they think. So I get paid for how I think. Here, let me share with you this journey of a bit over a couple of years ago, right? I have clients all over the world. I've got this one client there in Dubai, and they said, we want you to come and work for one of our other larger sister organizations. I asked them, who are they? And they said, we can't tell you. So I said, this is a little bit weird. So then I said, okay, what do they want me for? Do they want me to speak, do a keynote, do coaching or whatever? And they said to me, we can't tell you that either. I'm thinking this is weird, right? So I said, okay, how long do they want me for? Do they want me for one day or one week? Because that's all I'm going to give you. And then they said, we can't tell you that either. So it's either going to be for one day or one week. So I thought this is really dodgy, right? So I decided to charge them a ridiculous amount of money. Like we're talking about, you know, 20, 30 lakh plus. And they said, yes. So get this, I went to the Sydney airport, because I now live in Sydney with my wife and my three kids. So I went to the Sydney airport, and I don't know if you've heard of this. Catch this, ready? There are two airlines in the world that offer Prince class. What is Prince class? The entire front nose of the plane is your own cabin. There's a double-sized bed, there's a shower, a toilet, a massage room, right? On the plane. It's called Prince class, right? So I flew over to Dubai, Prince class, and again, I felt like a bit of a, you know, bit of a star, etc. And then when they touched down on the tarmac, I saw this car, big four-wheel drive, black, when it couldn't even see inside, drive onto the tarmac. They ushered this lift, these stairs, you know, to the front nose of the plane. They ushered me down the stairs, and I went inside this car, right? I'm thinking, man, this is pretty scary. And so then they drove me through to the back. So we did customs in the car. They drove me through the back streets of Dubai, and they ushered me into this door of the tallest building, yeah? So I went in there, and they put me in this back lift, and they took me to one of the top floors, right? I walked out the floor to ceiling. You can see right over the whole of Dubai, one of the nicest views I've ever seen. A long table up the back there, and there was maybe seven people that were sitting on that table, right? And what they wanted to do, they wanted to ask me questions to how I think about their current crisis that they were going through. Why? Because I'd positioned myself as a thought leader in how to overcome crises. So the reality is this. As a thought leader, we get paid for how we think. Yeah? But get this. Have you noticed there's now more thought leaders today than any other time in history?
Yes.
It's true, isn't it?
Yes.
Because we all get paid, because the reality is, this is all very self-proclaimed, isn't it? Look at me, I'm an expert. Look at me, I'm a thought leader. You know, there's no regulation to these terminologies, which basically means we now see it in email signatures, we see it on LinkedIn profiles, we see it on business cards. I'm an expert, I'm a thought leader, etc. It's all very self-proclaimed, which then means we need to differentiate ourselves even more.
Yes.
Which is where we become what we like to call an authority, right? Now, what an authority is when the buck stops with you. An authority is when people seek your opinion and your advice because you're the authority of your area of expertise. You're the commentator. Media seek your opinion because you are the translator of your industry sector. You understand?
Yes.
So look, this might be easier said than done, but hear me out. Hear me out. Ready? And I'm going to tell you exactly what I did. This here will change your life. Ready? Watch this. So I became, actually here, I'll do it here. I actually became a bit of after my car accident, I became an inspirational speaker. But then after seeing that there were so many other inspirational speakers, I needed to differentiate myself. So after reading the 10 of the best-selling books, after watching the TED Talks, after interviewing the people, I realized that, yes, I can now become a bit of an expert and a thought leader in how to overcome crises, crisis leadership, resilience, positive psychology, overcoming, etc. But after I immersed myself and found out what everyone else was talking about, I realized that everyone was talking about bouncing back. Do you know that there are 72 books out there, and in the book title it says bounce back? Look at bouncing back from the global financial crisis. We're bouncing back from terrorism. We're bouncing back from natural disasters. You know, you probably even used this terminology before. Come on, team, we need to bounce back. And if you think about it, there's something fundamentally wrong about this terminology. And trust me when I say terminology is going to be the key ingredient to you standing out from the marketplace, yeah? But this term bouncing back, there's something wrong. Because if you think about it, imagine this is you, yeah? This is you, either in your personal or your professional life, but you're moving forward, you're having your daily challenges like we always do, but then suddenly we hit a crisis, yeah? And through this crisis, we have a downturn, then we hit a place which is called rock bottom. Yeah, you with me? So we hit rock bottom. But then we're told, come on, let's bounce back to this place that got us to the problem in the first place. So there's something wrong about just that terminology. So hear me out. When everyone else was zigging, when everyone was talking about bouncing back, I decided to zag. And I wrote the very first book in the world called Bounce Forward. I disrupted my niche. When everyone was zigging, I decided to zag. Now, I haven't finished. Watch this. Bounce Forward could have just been another fluffy idea, right? Which then means I do a couple of nice little Instagram quotes, a couple of nice little blogs, a couple of ebooks, and then I move on to the next shiny thing. No, I focused on one thing, did it really well, and went deep with it. Us entrepreneurs, we come up with 65,000 ideas every single day. We don't have an ideas problem. We have a focus issue. Hear me out. Us entrepreneurs, we don't have an ideas problem. There's lots and lots of ideas out there. We don't have an ideas problem, we have a focus issue. Focusing on one thing, doing it really well, and going deep with it. You know, it's under my understanding that there are many people here in the room that are actually going through a bit of a transition in your life right now. And this transition is that you're lacking a bit of clarity of what tomorrow might look like for you. That you're lacking some clarity on what you really want to do in tomorrow's world, what the future might look like. And trust me when I say you need to learn how to differentiate yourself in the marketplace and become that authority in your industry sector. Because the reality is this, everything below the line is self-proclaimed. See this line right here? Everything below that line is self-proclaimed. Look at me, I'm a thought leader. Look at me, I'm an expert. But everything above the line is how the industry sees you. I don't have to say that I'm the authority of Bounce Forward. I am known as the authority of Bounce Forward. Do a Google search on Bounce Forward. I own the first 14 pages. One thing that you need to realize is that you need to have a one disruptive idea, which is four words or less. And this is part of your differentiating value proposition. Let me give you an example. On the first day of boot camp, we spend a lot of time on your DVP, on your differentiating value proposition, which basically means your how different and how are you standing out from the marketplace. So we had this one lady, she did boot camp. And in the first day, we work on your positioning and getting clarity on what's next for you. She came along, she didn't know what her differentiating value proposition is, and she's in finance. And so after reading the 10 of the best-selling books, after watching the TED Talks, after interviewing the people, we realized that everyone was talking about how to get rich fast. This is how you make $1 million in the shortest possible time. This is a get rich fast, get rich quick scheme. So through that, she then decided to zig when everyone else was zagging. So she wrote the very first book in the world called Get Rich Slow. Brilliant. She disrupted her niche. When everyone else was zigging, she decided to zag. What is your one disruptive idea? How are you standing out from the noise? because there's more noise in your space than any other time in history, and it's no longer good enough for you to be like everyone else. You know, when we're told when we're young kids, here's another one. You know, when we're told when we're young kids, don't talk to strangers. Do not talk to strangers. Another lady, she came along to boot camp, and then she wrote a book called Do Talk to Strangers. She disrupted her niche. When everyone else was zigging, she decided to zag. Let me give you one more. After me reading the 10 of the best-selling books in my field of story, after watching the TED Talks, after interviewing the people, I realized that everyone was talking about storytelling. Come on. I wrote the very first book on the planet called Story Showing. I disrupted my niche. When everyone else was zigging, I decided to zag. What is your one disruptive idea? How are you standing out from the noise? Because there's more noise in your space than any other time in history, and it is no longer good enough for you to be like everyone else. You must look at the terminology and clarity of your marketplace and how you're going to stand out. Because otherwise, you will get lost in the noise, and you will not be able to stand out. Thus, you won't be able to make the money. I'm telling you, find out exactly what your one disruptive idea is, and how can you position yourself in tomorrow's saturated market. So, let's now go back to our titles here, because I need you to put your hand up in one and only one. You can only put your hand up once, and I want you to think about you in the next 6 to 18 months. Now, don't you dare play a small game, because maybe you're here to start playing a bigger game. Maybe you're part of your calling today is to be that professional speaker. Maybe part of your calling today is to be that commentator, that translator, that authority in your marketplace. I don't know. But don't you play a small game. It's time for you to play a bigger game. I want you to start thinking of you in the next 6 to 18 months. Who are you? And I need you to put your hand up once and only once. So, in this room, who here in the next 6 to 18 months, it will be an intrapreneur, a corporate intrapreneur. Come on, put your hands up. Nice. Come on, loud and proud. Put your hand up. Come on, loud and proud. Only once, yep. Wait, keep your hand up, please. I want to see who you are. I want to acknowledge you. All right, keep your hand up. Just, great, excellent, hands down. Next one is this, a thought leader consultant. You run that practice. Come on, keep your hand up. Hands up nice and high. I just want to see you and acknowledge you. I want to see exactly where you're sitting. Yep. Great, hands down. Next one here is a professional speaker. Come on, nice and high, loud and proud. Come on, professional speaker. Just keep your hand up, keep it up. You put your hand up twice. Keep it up. I notice everything. Keep your hand up. Great, hands down. Next one is this, a business entrepreneur. Come on, hands up. Come on, loud and proud, put your hand up. Now keep it up. I just want to see you and acknowledge you. Just keep it up. Great. Excellent, hands down. And then the last one is an expert authority. Come on, put your hand up loud and proud, nice and high. Keep it up. Yeah, you put your hand up twice too. All right, wait, keep it up. Great, excellent, awesome. Give yourselves a round of applause. Great. All right, we are now going to start with our first piece of content here in today's program. We literally haven't even started. So again, this morning we're talking about two main pieces of our influence. The first one is our content, what we say. The second is our methodology, how we say it. So we're going to spend some time right now on our content, first of all. Then after lunch, then we're going to spend some time on our methodology. But content is still important, yeah? So we're going to do this through what we like to call our authority communication framework. This is the framework that we teach our TED speakers. This is the framework that we teach people that are pitching to an organization to get them across the line. This is also the framework that we teach our keynote speakers, those speakers that want to speak internationally. This is the exact framework that we teach anyone at all who wants to influence anyone and get them across the line. So, while I'm communicating this, can I please encourage you here today to, you know, wait until we reveal it all, and then you can ask questions. Because sometimes we have found that you're asking a question before we are revealing it, yeah? So it's really important that you do wait for that as we do go along. All right. Are you having fun?
Yes.
Turn to the person next to you and just say, this was better than what I thought. Come on, this was better than what... Ha, 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 ha. All right. Let's start with our first piece of content here today. The first thing is this. Whenever you are talking to anyone, whenever you want to influence anyone at all, you must address their problem straight up. I don't care about your story at all. I don't care about your idea at all. I don't care about your product. I don't care about stats. I don't care about facts. I don't even care about your content. All I care about is my problem. Address my problem straight up, and I will give you my ear. Now, if I was you, exaggerate the problem. Seriously, exaggerate their problem. So now the listener's going, oh my gosh, man, this isn't just a problem, this is a crisis. Give me the antidote. Give me your solution. So then you come up with the idea. Now your idea is either the product, the services, or your message. Again, your idea is either your product, your services, or your message. Now, the reality is this. 33% of audiences and listeners are either going to be academics or skeptics, which basically means they're going, the very first thing they're going to think about is prove it to me. They are. Give me the stats. Give me the facts. Give me the data. Give me the research. Give me the case study. Prove to me that that idea is the solution to my problem. So then you give them evidence. You show, get this ready, you show them evidence that your idea is the solution to their problem.
You understand?
Yes.
So now that you've shown to them that your idea is the solution to their problem, you've now connected with their heads. It now makes sense. It does. However, get this ready. Have you guys noticed when something makes sense, we're still not necessarily influenced? Our gut isn't connected. It's so true. Yeah, let me give you an example. Let's say my wife and I, my wife and I were going shopping for a washing machine, ticket. So here we are, we're looking at this washing machine, and the salesperson comes up and gives us all the features, all the benefits to this washing machine. And so for me, he's informed me, and it makes sense. So I'm now thinking, let's buy it, right? But then my wife, get this, ready, get this. Then my wife, she says to me, Sam, I'm not feeling it. Do you think we're going to buy that washing machine? No chance at all. Write this down. This is the most powerful phrase that you will hear all day today. Write this down. I am in the business of emotion. Write it down. I am in the business of emotion. If you are not evoking emotion into the listener, you have lost them. You can inform all you like through stats, facts, data, and analytics. But if you're not evoking emotion, you're not going to get them across the line at all. You are in the business of emotion. And if you can evoke emotion into the listener, then you can influence anyone. So then that means is this. How do we evoke emotion? Yes, we do it through a story. We know that, yeah? However, the story is only there to show that an idea is the solution to their problem through a case study or a story, which then means that that story is more of a metaphor. So basically, that story is only there to show that that idea is the solution to their problem. Now, the beauty of this is this. Watch this, ready? This is going to blow your mind. Ready? Watch this. Your metaphor, my encouragement to you straight up, is to use your own story, right? For those people that put their hand up this morning and was speaking, and particularly a couple of ladies, what we saw there was a real sense of vulnerability, right? And now the word vulnerability comes from the Latin word vulnerabilis, means an open wound. You know what's really interesting? Nowadays, we do not want those speakers or those influencers to say, hey, look at me, I'm successful and I've only been successful, hoorah! We don't want that anymore, do you know what we want? We want authenticity. We want vulnerability. We want those speakers and those influencers to say, hey guys, I've failed. I've failed time and time again, but I've learned through that failure. Let me share with you. I cannot encourage you enough to open a wound and share with us your authenticity and vulnerability, because now you've been more likable. Now I'm going to lean into what you have to say. Trust-based selling, yeah? We know that, yeah? Which then means this. Your metaphor utilizes the top three in its chronological order. This is genius. Watch this, right? This is beauty. Watch this. There was this one time when I had the problem just like you. And through this problem, I was losing 10% of my bottom line week in, week out. And it wasn't until such time as we implemented this idea, and now just in the last 3 months alone, we've seen a 90% turnaround. Oh, did you see that? Did you see it? Did you see it? Did you see it? Your metaphor is purely a story utilizing the top three in its chronological order. Now, if they already know you, if you've already opened a wound, if you've already shared your own story, then the metaphor can then be a case study of someone that you've worked with. Watch this. There was this one time when where we were working with a client and they had exactly the same problem as you. And they actually lost 30% of their bottom line within a few months. And it wasn't until such time as they implemented our idea, now they've seen a 300% turnaround in the last 3 months alone since them implementing our idea. Did you see that? Did you see it? Did you see it? Your metaphor is purely utilizes the top three in its chronological order. That is brilliant. Which then means this. You've influenced me now. I'm ready. Like, you've actually now influenced me. You've addressed my problem. You've exaggerated. But then you've given me a solution, which is your idea to my problem. Now I'm a skeptic. So then you've connected with my head through evidence. Now you've connected with my heart through a metaphor, through a story. Now I'm ready. I'm ready. You've actually influenced me, which then means, you know, show me what's next. So then you then mention your call to action. This is like your formula. This is like your teachable framework. This is how I can buy from you. This is your how-to. Give me your how-to. I want to learn your how-to. I'll give you an example. Ready? Watch this. Ready? Your call to action is basically a formula, yeah? So let's say your formula could be something. Let's say your formula could be something like this. So today, guys, I actually want to show you our four-step cycle in order for you to go from where you are today to where you really want to be. Or today, guys, I actually want to show you our three-phase system here in order for you to go from where you are today to where. So what I want to do right now, I want to show you how you can work from the outside in. And the reality is this. Catch this, ready? If you've read the 10 of the best-selling books, if you've watched the TED Talks, if you've interviewed people, you have what we like to call intellectual property, which basically means you can make this up. You can make it up. That's the beauty of it. You've had experiences in your life, and through these experiences you've learned something, and I haven't learned it yet. Teach me how to learn it. Give me your how-to. Give me your formula. Give me your teachable framework. You've learned something. I haven't learned it yet. Teach me it. So this here is your call to action. Are you with me?
Yes.
Do you understand what I'm talking about?
Yes.
Great. So now we're halfway through. So the reality is this. Is that I actually believe that there is way too much noise in the marketplace right now. And if you're not communicating short and sharp and direct and straight to the point, you're going to lose the game of influence. Which then means that we need to get rid of all those words that shouldn't be there. I'm going to give you sentences under each one of these elements. And these sentences here are something that you can just simply finish off. So one thing you'll realize about our programs here at Speakers Institute, we hold your hand very, very easily catchable elements of our program. So anyone could catch it. Because again, you know our attention span, right? If you're not communicating short, sharp, direct, and bite-sized chunks, you're losing the game of influence. The media call it sound bites. You have to learn this. You must. If you want to influence marketplace, you must learn how to communicate in short, sharp bites. Let's have a look at sentences under each one of these. I like this. Ready? Watch this. Under problem, have you ever felt? You know, we do everything for how it makes us feel. We dress for how it makes us feel. We eat for how it makes us feel. We come to seminars for how it makes us feel. We're in relationships for how it makes us feel. We earn money for how it makes us feel. We're in business for how it makes us feel. We do everything for how it makes us feel. So then suddenly then someone comes up to you and says, hey, have you ever felt this? Oh, yeah, man. We're exaggerating the problem, yeah? So if we're exaggerating the problem, oh my gosh, man, this isn't just a feeling, this is a crisis. Give me the antidote, give me your solution. So then you say, well, I have found that. I have found that my product, my services, my message is the solution to your problem. Now, the listener is skeptic now. So they're saying, prove it to me. Show me evidence, show me facts, show me stats, show me research, show me the evidence that your idea is the solution to my problem. So then you say, well, research tells us that.
Oh, this is good.
Research tells us that the people that implement our idea, they realize that this is the solution to their problem. Research tells us that the people that have your problem and implement our idea, if that is the solution. So now you're connected with my head. But again, just because you're connected with my head and my gut isn't connected, I'm still not going to take out my wallet because it doesn't feel right yet. Which then means you need a metaphor. You need a story. I like this one. This is my favorite. Ready? Watch. Ready? There was this one time when. Oh, that's good. That's good. So again, there was this one time when I felt this, and then we found this, and research tells us that it worked. Come on. There was this one time when I felt this, and then we found this, and research tells us that it worked. So now I'm influenced. Now I'm ready. I'm ready. You've connected with you've addressed my problem, you've given me a solution, you've shown me that it works through both evidence, with connecting with head, through connect with story, and now I'm ready. Give me your call to action. So then, I like this one as well. Ready? Watch this, ready? Today I want to show you how to. Give me your how to. I want to learn your how to. Give me your how-to. You've got experiences in your life and you've got a how-to. I want to learn your how-to. Teach me your how-to. I want to learn your how-to. Teach me your how-to. What is your formula? What is your system? What is your process? What are the things that you've learned? I want to learn that. What is your teachable framework? We all have one. Come on, hands up in this room. If this piece in our program gave you value here this morning, put your hand up. Come on, put your hand up. Great, excellent. Again, you've come to the right room, which is awesome. The decision that you made here to come here was certainly the right decision. So, questions. Runners with our mic runners. Can we be ready, please? Thank you. Come on, questions. We've got one over here. I'll get you to stand up, and we've got a microphone there for you.
What happens when this is done in various phases? You know, I'm putting a hat of a consultant, for example, and you're doing it as a workshop for spread across various weeks.
Okay. Hey, watch this. Ready? Okay, guys, just watch this. Ready? I'm about to show you how this works. Ready? This is genius. Just hear me out. Lean in. What do you do? Tell me what you do.
Typically, you'll prepare material accordingly and content accordingly. Based on the agenda agreed in the previous meeting, taking this framework.
No, what do you do? What's your business?
IT.
IT. And what specifically do you do in IT?
Cybersecurity.
So I've never met this gentleman, and all I've heard was what you guys heard as well, yeah? So I want you to watch this. Grab a seat and watch this. Ready? I want you guys to multitask for me in a moment, yeah? What multitask is, I want you to watch where I put this and then watch exactly what I'm communicating as well to you, yeah? So I want you to multitask for me because I'm going to put every single one of these sentences in exactly what I've just heard here today. So I want you to watch really closely and multitask for me. Ready? Watch this. Ready? Watch. Let me give you your attention. Ready? Watch this. Have you ever felt that whenever you're online with your computer, you want to make sure that you have the right protection, the right malware, the right cyber security within your program, whether you run a business, whether you're in a team, or even when you are by yourself. I have found when you have the right cyber security for your company, for your personal life, this will ensure that you are protected from any malicious malware. You know, research tells us that the people that arrange with our company and help you with your cybersecurity, these are the people that have more peace of mind and the people that are a lot more protected than others. There was one time when I didn't have cybersecurity. And I was open to attacks from the marketplace. And I found myself that they were attacking us in a cyber way through malware. And it wasn't until such time as we created the right cyber security for our organization. And now today we're seeing a huge turnaround. So today I want to show you how you too can have the right cyber security. So you will ensure that you'll never ever be attacked again. The reality is that the formula works. Yes. And then if you learn the formula, yes, you can change one or two words, but the formula does work. So just trust the process and you will get the outcome. Very quick question there. I'll get you to stand up. Quick, mic runners, quick.
Go. Hi, I'm Yogita San. My question is, right from the beginning, I'm listening to you. You said story showing, right? Towards the end also, you are saying, I want to show, right?
Yep.
Since you have been working with John Grinder himself, so I'm sure you are well-versed with NLP and New Code NLP, right?
I've never ever studied
NLP. Okay, anyways. So, you have never studied, but since John Grinder is working with you, definitely he's using his things. I have been certified by John Grinder himself in New Code NLP. So people are, you know, taking information in three forms. Either they are auditory, they want to hear, they want to listen, they want to use more of this. Then there are visual people who will very well go with this. I want to show you, see this, do this, okay? And the third one is, say, kinesthetic. I did not feel the way you said washing machine. My wife said, I did not feel. Okay. So, will it work with, the question is, will it work with the auditory and kinesthetic people as well? And the digital ones who are very good with words. Like you are good with words and you are a visual person, what I could see. So, will this work with only the visual people or will this work with auditory, kinesthetic and the digital ones?
And thank you very much.
Thank you.
We haven't even started on methodology. This is pure content, what we say. When we start looking at the methodology, we're going to take it to a whole nother level. We're not, like, again, this year is only 20 to 30% of the influence and impact of the listener. That's it. Now, yes, it also does depend on who your audiences are. I'll give you an example. Ready? Watch this, ready? There's a thing which we like to call an energy timeline. So watch this, ready? One of the energy timeline is this here. So write this down if you can. You've got high energy, you've got low energy, and then you've got even par, yeah? So what high energy is those people that, you know, like Tony Robbins, hoorah, look at me, high five, give five people a high five and yell and scream, yes! You know, that is high energy. And then you've got low energy. So what's low energy? Low energy is like this. When I woke up out of a coma, I was in a complete and utter state of denial. This hasn't happened to me. I haven't really lost my arm. It's okay. I'm going to wake up from this nightmare. For 2 days, look, Sam, you haven't really wrecked your leg. You haven't really lost your arm. It's okay. You're in this really bad movie. It's going to end soon. So that's low energy, yeah? And then you've got even par. What even par is, here are the three ways to help you to, here are the five secret ingredients that will, here are the seven phase formula that can, here are the nine principles that will, by the way, we learn in odd numbers rather than even numbers, there's a whole other conversation, yeah? So watch this, ready? Let's say hypothetically, you are speaking to a bunch of young people, yeah? So young people, where does their energy need to be? Watch this, ready? That's what young people want, correct?
Yes.
Absolutely. So let's say now you're talking to a bunch of, let's say adults. And so adults need to be more like this. Would you agree?
Yes.
Absolutely. So now let's say you're talking to a bunch of C-level executives. Yeah? So then that means for C-level executives, the energy timeline would be more like this. So understanding the context of your audience. Because trust me when I say that research will tell us that if you are in a live room, the majority of people are going to be more visual learners rather than kinesthetic audio. If you're in a live room. Clearly, if you listen to a podcast, then it's going to be different. So look at some of the latest research that's coming out. Yes, some of the data that has been around for generations, it's still not relevant today. But one thing I'd like for you to consider is always consider who your audiences are. What is the context of your audience and who are they? That way then you can help them on that journey and manage your own energy in the way that you communicate. Because trust me, it's exactly the same content, but it's then understanding the methodology and how to deliver that content, which is going to be the powerful one. So in saying that, guys, I actually now want to spend between now and lunch, so we're going to have lunch about half an hour. I want to spend a bit of time here on metaphor, because clearly we've come here more around show rather than tell, and I'm going to give you an insight. We haven't even started story showing yet, by the way. We haven't even started. We're only looking at our content, what we say. Actually, before I do that, I wanted to show you a testimonial here from someone that recently came along to our boot camp. And she lives in Perth in Western Australia. And then she saw that I was going back over there. And she sent me this Facebook message, and I'm going to show it to you guys today. This is what she said. She said, "Hey, Sam, I see you're doing an event in Perth. I'll be very happy to come along and big up your courses for you and tell my story from going from nearly selling my business and having no idea where I was going to this time last year to now." So in most cases, guys, sometimes we don't realize that we actually, do you have a 2030 vision for your business? Let me give you an example on that. Most of us in this room have kids, yeah? And let's say if you do have a child or a kid, you're already thinking about where they're going to study, what they're going to do, where you're going to encourage them to go towards. We've already thought about them in longer than 10 years' time, correct?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes.
When was the last time you did this for your business? Have you thought about your 2030 vision? Have you thought about exactly where you need to go, in where you need to be in 2030? Because by the way, that's how I think. And that's why you need a mentor and a coach around you. That's why you need to upgrade your proximity. Because if you can do that for your child, why aren't you doing it for your business? From going from nearly selling this time to no idea where I was going to this time last year, to now having total clarity. She wrote charity, but she was meant to write clarity, right? And then she wrote, "I made nearly $1 million. What's that? That's 5 crore in the last 4 months alone. Who in this room would like to earn 5 crore in 4 months? Come on, put your hand up. Be honest. Come on, there's still people here. I don't want to earn 5 crore in 4 months. Come on. We all want to earn 5 crore in 4 months. Everything I have now stemmed from joining your camp. I'm very happy to share the value of God if you want me to." Actually, you are right. It is 10 crore. It is 10 crore. 1 million US is 10 crore. Sorry, Australian is 10 crore. She earned 10 crore in 4 months from boot camp. She's written it down on a Facebook. And now, look, you guys might be thinking, look, maybe I'm not as good as Sarah. So let's say if you're only 50% as good as Sarah. Let's say you got 50% return on investment through bootcamp. So just remember, to upgrade me, I spent 2 crore on me. Yeah? Now let's say if Sarah, if she wanted, let's say you only got 50% better results than Sarah. Only 50%. Which then means, because 1 million is 10 crore, huh? Which then means if you got 50% of what Sarah got, you would earn 5 crore. Okay, let's say hypothetically you only got 25% results from boot camp to what Sarah got. 25%, which is 2.5 crore. Who in this room would like to earn 2.5 crore in 4 months? Come on, 2.5 crore. She did that in 4 months. Times four. What I want to do, I want to show you very quickly this video here. This is a beautiful example of story showing. And so we're going to deep dive over the next half an hour specifically in show rather than tell. I want to show you this very quick video here, which shows you guys a little bit more about show rather than tell. Let's have a watch of this. Very good. The screenwriter there, his name is Pete Docter. Pete Docter did a lot of Pixar and also Disney animated works. Obviously, this is the opening 3.5 minutes of a feature-length movie, which is called Up. Beautiful example of story showing. They didn't tell you anything. They didn't tell you. There was no dialogue. They just showed you a journey. Yet it evoked emotion. Tell me something. What was the moral of the story? Come on. What's the moral of the story? What's the moral of the story? Don't wait. Don't wait. Maybe you've been waiting for too long. Don't wait. YOLO, you only got one life. There are five stages of story showing. Stage one, understanding, identifying, outcome. Every single story has to have outcome. If there's no outcome at all, I'm thinking, why are you even sharing this story in the first place? Yeah? So you must have an outcome for the story. What is the call to action? Where are you leading them? What do you want them to think about at the end of that story? What specifically is the outcome to the story? Story showing stage two, meaningful process that is interesting. There is nothing worse when you hear a boring story and you think, hurry up and finish already. You must make sure that the story is interesting. And don't get me wrong, the story is not about the content, what you say, but it's more about the methodology, how you say it. Story showing stage three connects with each listener and takes us on a memorable journey. You must make sure that the story lands well for the listener and it is memorable. You know, get this ready. You know what the greatest sin of communication is? You know what the greatest sin of communication is? Being easily forgettable. Think about that. The greatest sin of communication is being easily forgettable. When you've had an opportunity to get my attention, and then when you leave, I've forgotten it straight away, you've wasted my time and you've wasted your time. The greatest sin of communication is being easily forgettable, which basically means if you have to communicate, particularly in a story, you must make sure it is memorable. Why do you want your story to be memorable? Because maybe if it lands well for me, I'm going to go out and tell other people and my friends and my family about that story that I've just heard from you. I'm now your ambassador. Come on. Actually, get this. The other day, I was walking through the airport of Singapore. Like, literally, I just did Singapore before I came here. And someone at the Singapore airport 3 days ago, she came up to me. And she tapped me on the shoulder and I turned around, didn't know her at all. And this is what she said. She goes, hi, are you Sam Cawthorne? And I said, yeah. She goes, wow. I said, what? And she goes, my mum heard you speak 5 years ago. And now she didn't hear me speak. It was her mum. So her mum then told her all about it. She then remembered this 5 years later. Then she's going, oh yeah, you speak about Bounce Forward, you had a car, wow, that's amazing, let's take a photo, let's get a selfie, like, let's get an autograph. Like, the ultimate outcome of every story is when other people tell the story that you've just told them. Come on! That's the, like, come on, my hope here today is that you will leave the room and then you'll go and tell your family, your friends, your colleagues about this one-armed Indian Tasmanian Scotsman guy that showed you how to be a story shower rather than a teller. Of course, that's my intention. Come on. The ultimate outcome is be memorable. Story showing stage four captivates and demonstrates a sense of anticipation through verbal and nonverbal. Again, it's not about your content, what you say. It's about your nonverbal intelligence, how you say it. And then you created anticipation. You are at the edge of their seat. We're waiting for the next thing that happens in the story. And stage five masters the science of the art and brings in emotional effectiveness. If you are not in the of emotion and evoking emotion into the listener, then all you're doing is just informing the listener. You must evoke emotion and be in the business of emotion, because there is a science to the art of effective story showing. So, in saying all that, I think we've been sitting down for a lot now. I'm actually now going to do an activity, and in a moment I'm going to bring someone up here on stage and we're going to show you exactly how to story show. What you're about to see over the next 15, 20 minutes is going to be mastery. Okay, just hear me out on that. So First of all, I want to do an exercise here, and I want you guys to get into in a moment into small groups, but it's this. 6 ways to communicate a story that will ensure you lose the audience. We're actually going to have a bit of fun first. Yeah? Seriously, we need to find out what not to do before we find out what to do. Yeah? So, I need everyone now to put your pens and paper down, and I want you to get in groups of 3, please. Quickly, groups of 3. That means you're going to have to talk to people. That means you're going to have to interact with people and then decide who is person A, B, or C. Come on, get in groups of 3. Person A, B, or C. Person A, person B, person C. Come on, trainers. Person A, B, and C. Wait, don't leave. This is going to be a game changer. Now. Hey, very quickly, can I just grab your attention? Wait, let me just grab your attention for a moment. So what I if you can't find a group of 3, a group of 2 is absolutely okay. And I want you to do person A, person B, person C. Quickly decide who is person A, B, and C. So person A, please put your hands up. Come on. Person A, person A, person A. Come on. Who's person A? Who's person A? Put your hand up, person. Come on, who's person A? Over here. Shh. Who's person A? Put your hand up. A's. Put your hand up. Person A, put your hands down. Person B, put your hand up. Actually, person B and person C, put your hand up. B's and C's. B's and C's, put your hand up. B's and C's, what I want you to do right now, I want you to point towards person A. Come on, point toward. That's right, person A, you're going first. You're going first. So, wait, what I want you to do right now, person A, I want you to stay standing up. Everyone else sit down. Come on, person A, you are stay standing up. Person A, you are standing up. Everyone else sits down. So, person A, what I'd like for you to do right now, I want you, person A, I want you to stay standing up. I want you to look down at your team. And in a moment, I want you to then communicate to your team what brought you here today. So it might be something like, well, I was on Facebook, or, you know, or Ashutosh got in contact with me, or whatever it is, right? Share with us the story of what brought you here today. But watch this. I want you to share the story as if you're an incessant talker that doesn't breathe. So watch this. Ready? So watch this. So person A, what I want you to do in a moment, I want you to stay standing up. I want you to look down at your team. I want you to communicate a story of what brought you here today. But I want you to communicate the story as if you're an incessant talker that doesn't breathe. Person A, are you ready? Go! Come on, go. Incessant talker doesn't breathe. Incessant talker doesn't breathe. Come here, quickly. Give him a hand, give him a clap. Sit down. Person B, stand up. Person B, stand up now. Person B, stand up. Person B, what I want you to do, person B, I want you to stay standing up. I want you to look down at your team. I want you to communicate a story of what brought you here today. But person B, I want you to communicate the story as if you're on Red Bull, crazy eyes, hyper hand. Watch this, ready? Watch this. Person B, ready? These are the type of people that have crazy eyes because they've just drunk 6 cans of Red Bull. So person 2, person B, what I want you to do, I want you to act as if you just drunk. Ready, set, go! Go, go, go! Alright, well done. Give him a hand, give him a clap. Clap, give him a clap, come on. Give him a clap, give him a clap, give him a clap. Give him a clap, give him a clap. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down. Wait. Shh. Shh. Person B, you enjoyed that a little bit too much. Next person, stand up. Come on, next person, next person, stand up. Next person, stand up. Next person, next person. Next person, what I want you to do, I want you to stay standing up. I want you to look down at your team. I want you to communicate a story of what brought you here today. But I want you to communicate the story as if you have just swallowed too many pills. Share your story medicated. Go.
give him a hand, give him a clap, give him a clap, give him a clap, give him a clap, give him a clap. Sit down, sit down. Next person, stand up, we have a shit. Next person, stand up. Next person, again. Again, next person, again, next person. Next person, stand up, next person. What I want you to do, I want you to stay standing up, look down at your team, communicate a story of what brought you here today, but I want you to communicate the story as if you are the hand dropper. Now, I'm going to show you how to do this. I'm going to take off my jacket. Shh. Now, I need everyone to see me. If you can't see me, move or stand up so you can see me. It is very important that you see me right. Watch, watch, watch. Ready? Watch. Watch me really closely. Ready? So we communicate with our hands. But as soon as I drop my hand, I've put a full stop at the end of my sentence. And I've given my audience permission to relax. Now watch this. Ready? Watch this. Watch this. But if I keep my hand up, you guys are still anticipating what I'm going to say next. Watch this. And then and only then, when I drop my hand, I've given my audience permission to relax and I put a full stop at the end of my sentence. Watch, 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 watch. Isn't that amazing? Yeah. So, next person, what I want you to do right now is to drop your hand. Come on, after each few words. Come on, next person, next person. Ready, set, go. To your team, come on, to your team. Oh, well done. Give him a hand, give him a clap, give him a clap, give him a clap. Next person, stand up. We haven't finished yet. Next person, stand up. We haven't finished. We haven't finished. We haven't finished. Next person, next person, next person. Next person, what I want you to do, I want you to stay standing up. I want you to look down at your team. I want you to communicate a story of what brought you here today. Shh. But I want you to communicate the story as if you have chin insecurity. Now watch this. Ready? Ready? Watch this. Ready? Watch this. These are the type of people who think they're a lot more smarter than everyone else. But they need to make sure that their chin is still attached to their face. Communicate your story with chin insecurity. Come on, ready, set, go. Come on, let's go. Oh, well done, give me a hand, give me a hand, give me a clap, give me a clap, give me a clap. Last person, stand up, last person, step, last person. Last person, stand up. Last person, what I want you to do, I want you to stay standing up. I want you to look down at your team. I want you to communicate a story of what brought you here today. But I want you to communicate the story, ready, watch this, ready, watch this, as if you're the pointy teacher. Ready, so ready? These are the type of people who always have their finger in your face. And you think, get your finger out of my face right now. Communicate your story if you're the pointy teacher. Ready, set, go. Come on, go, 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 go. Just put him there, just put him there. Oh, give him a hand, give him a clap, give him a clap, give him a clap. Give him. High five your team, give him a high five. High five your team, high five your team, high five your team, high five your team. Six ways to communicate a story that will ensure you lose the conversation. As you can see there, we all know those incessant talkers, those people that actually talk really, really fast all the time, and you just think, just slow down for a moment here. Yeah? And then you got those people on Red Bull. And you know, and get this ready, I need to be very consciously aware that I don't come across Red Bull. Why? Because I just get excited sometimes, right? So I need to rein that in to make sure I'm leveling with the right audience. The next one there is medicated. You know, with those people, you just think, just hurry up and finish already, yeah? And then you've got the hand dropper. Fascinating. Here's guy. Guys, I'm about to give you another game changer. Watch, wait, ready, watch this. Everyone watch me, watch me, watch me. Ready, watch this. So yes, we communicate with our hands,
But we only move our hands when we speak. Because if I move my hands when I'm not communicating, it's different to the way that I'm communicating. So yeah, so you only move your hands when you speak. And then when you pause, you freeze the gesture. Yeah? And then when you speak, you move your hand. So again, when you speak, you move. When you pause, you freeze. Watch, 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 watch. It's really watch this. You know, right now, you might actually be losing out on money, losing people's attention, and you don't even know why. You must learn how to influence more people, particularly from a one-to-many point of view. You've got to learn this, and the only way to learn it is by getting quality feedback. You cannot get feedback from the people that are not qualified to give you feedback. Because some of the stuff that we're going to show you here, particularly this afternoon, is going to blow your mind. It's something that you haven't seen done before. So now we've found out what not to do. Now let's find out what to do. Oh, this is the time that we've been waiting for, correct?
Yes!
All right. So this here is our content. Again, the content is the easy part. Now we're going to have a snapshot of what we'll be doing this afternoon, yeah? So our content is the easy part. So for me, I live in Sydney, and for me, I want to visit New York. But for you, I live in Delhi, and for you, say you want to visit Paris or whatever it is, yeah? But for me, I live in Sydney, I want to live in New York. Now, I want you to watch me like a hawk. Ready? Watch my fingers, watch my wrist, watch my elbow, watch from the waist down, from the waist up, watch my shoulders, watch my head, look at my facial muscles, watch my eyes, watch how often I blink, watch even where I swallow. I want you to then listen to my tonality, listen to how long I pause and long I don't pause, listen to how I end my sentences, high or low. I want you to watch everything. Because everything I do is orchestrated. I do it purposefully. Trust me when I say there is another level that you haven't tapped into yet. And so in a moment, I'm going to show you what to do. I'm going to show you how to do it. And then I'm going to bring someone from the audience up here on stage, and I'm going to coach them live in front of everyone. Don't let that someone be someone else. Because what happens is there is a pride. I already know this stuff. No, you don't know it. Trust me, you don't know it. Or there's a pride. I want to let other people have a go, and I'm just going to observe and watch other people have a go. And that's a pride. You know the reason why we get shy on stage is because of pride. Did you know that? The reason why we get nervous on stage is because of pride. Do you know why? Because we're so worried about what everyone else thinks of you. Let me give you a reality check. It's not about you. It never has been about you. But when we get on stage, we're so worried about what everyone else thinks of you. You are self-centered. Pure self-centered. That's all you care about, is what other people think of you. It's not about you. It's about the service that you can be. What a privilege it is to be on stage. I don't take that lightly. And so if you're winging it, if you're making it up on the spot, what a disrespect that is to your audience. What an honor it is to be on stage. What an honor it is for me to have your attention. I don't want to take that lightly. So I don't know if you speak on stage, but you better start going to a whole nother level. Because I don't take speaking on stage lightly at all. I want to make sure that I add value. I serve. I contribute. So I want you to watch me really closely. So again, the content's easy. I live in Sydney, but where I really want to visit is New York. But I want you to watch everything that I do. And then I'm going to bring someone up here on stage and I'm going to coach them through it. Don't let that someone be someone else. Watch me, ready? Watch, 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 ready? I live in Sydney, but where I'd really like to visit is New York. I'm going to do that again. And then I'm going to bring someone up here. I'm going to take him through exactly what I'm doing here. Everything is orchestrated. Again, no video. Watch, ready? I live in Sydney, but where I'd really like to visit is New York. Who wants to go?
This gentleman here, he was standing up, so I'm actually going to give it to this gentleman here. Come on, give him a hand. Come on, jump up on stage. Oh, no, I'd prefer no mic, sorry. Okay, just stand here. Now, do you want to see me do it once more, or are you ready?
I would prefer to repeat it.
All right. Just stay there then. I'm going to do it over there, just so you guys can see me, but also you can see me as well. Watch really closely, and then it's your turn, yeah? Watch this. I live in Sydney, but where I'd really like to visit is New York. Your turn. Present to us, yeah?
I live in Delhi.
Okay, so there's a couple of things here. The reason why we put our hand to our chest is because we take ownership of it. If you want to come across with more congruency, if you want other people to trust you more, if you want to showcase that you are certain and you're backing yourself, you must put your hand to your chest whenever you're talking about you or your business. Watch this, ready? This is who we are. This is what I do. This is what we do. This is who I am. This is where I live. Now that's an accent. I can't go, I live. Can't do that. Or I can't go, I live. No. It's an accent. Everyone try it. Come on, everyone try it. You as well. Come on, everyone try it. Ready? Everyone try it. Ready? 1, 2, 3. I live. Wait a sec. It's not I live. No, that's not an accent. As you touch, then you say. This is called the submodalities. And this is subconscious as well, yeah? And so you would learn a lot of this at our boot camp because we're going to teach you exactly how to unpack this. Let's try it again. Ready? Let's try it again. Ready? 1, 2, 3. I live. Great. Yep. So it has to be open. Try not to be it open. That way you're owning this. I've upgraded this. I can't say it's this. I live. Yeah.
I live in Delhi.
Okay. Close. Now watch this. Ready? Watch this. What I'm about to now share with you is the start of showing rather than telling. I'm about to give you a total game changer, and also I'm about to teach you how to unlearn some stuff that you've been taught, which is fundamentally wrong. Watch this. Your audience will follow your eyes, but your eyes follow your hands. I'll say that again. You got to catch this. Your audience will follow your eyes, but your eyes follow your hands. You must start showing rather than saying. Watch this, ready? Let's say hypothetically, my car accident was here, the ambulance was here, and the hospital is there. Watch this, ready? Guys, the other day I actually had this major car accident, and basically they cut me out of the accident, they put me in the ambulance, then they drove me to the hospital. Now watch this. Guys, the other day I actually had a major car accident. What happened? They cut me out of the car, they put me in the ambulance, and they drove me to the hospital. It doesn't work! Tell does not work when you look at the audience. You have to show. Show the story. Show parts of where things are in this story. You have to start showing rather than telling. You know what we've always been taught by other trainers? Always look at the audience. Look at them in the eye. Always look where... No, it's fundamentally wrong in story. You must look where the story is. So watch this then. So then that means then, watch this, ready? I live in Delhi. Now watch this. I'm going to keep my hand in Delhi, but then look at you. Yeah? So ready? I live in Delhi, but I'm still in Delhi. I haven't said the next place yet. I'm still in Delhi, but where I really... I'm still in Delhi, but where I really want to visit... I'm still in Delhi, but where I really want to visit... I'm still in Delhi, but where I really want to visit is... Bang! See that? Did you see it?
Yes.
Guys, I'm telling you, we're going to unlock all of this this afternoon straight after lunch. This will be a game changer for you. Let's try it. Ready? No. Look at us. So by the way, here's another thing. Ready? Watch this. In the marketplace right now, over the last 10 to 15 years, there's been unprecedented change. And through that change, the market is more uncertain than any other time in history. You know what they want from us? You know what they want from us? They want certainty. You know where 80% of certainty comes from? Your eyes. When you then did this, right? This is what his eyes looked like. I live in Delhi. There's no certainty. We look at your eyes, get this, subconsciously, we look at his eyes like a hawk. And the moment that he shows uncertainty in his eyes, he's lost our trust.
like some of the stuff that you will learn in boot camp, particularly around the power of the eyes, and how whenever you talk about dollar value, you have to be very conscious of where you put your eyes. Like, the more often you blink, the more uncertain you come across. My mentor has taught me not to blink for up to 2 hours. You guys are now looking at me. Is he blinking? Is he blinking? Is he blinking? Is he blinking? All right, watch this. Ready? Let's do it again. Ready? So look at us. So watch this. Ready? I live in Delhi, but where I really want to visit is... Where do you want to visit, by the way? Paris? New York?
Sydney.
Great. High five. Best city in the world. Ready? So see, yeah. So I live in Delhi, but where I really want to visit is Sydney. Let's try it.
I live in Delhi.
Now keep your hand, keep your hand in Delhi. Keep your hands in Delhi. Keep it in Delhi. Look, keep your hands in Delhi. Keep your hands in Delhi. Now look at us, look at us, look at us, look at us, look at us. Now look at Delhi. Where's Delhi? Where's Delhi? Correct. Look at Delhi. Now look at us. Look at us. Now where's Delhi? Where's Delhi? Where's Delhi? Where's Delhi? Look at Delhi. Don't look at me. Don't look at me. Look at Delhi. Look at us. Look at us. Now look at Delhi. Now show me. Shh. Now show me where Sydney is. Where's Sydney? No. Not here. Look, he's looking at me. Sydney isn't here. Sydney is there. No, look. Look. Look at. Don't look at me. Okay. Look there. Let's try again. Let's try again. Let's try again. Hey, and by the way, catch this. It is a lot harder than what it looks. Do you know why? Because he's unlearning right now. You have been taught elements in story that is fundamentally wrong. And if you don't learn this stuff, you will not stand out from storytellers. You won't. This stuff here, it cost me over 2 crore to learn. What you're learning right now is 2 crore worth of investment that I learnt in. And you won't learn this anywhere in the world. You want to go and do public speaker training? Go and pay what other people are charging, which is what, 10, 20 lakh, huh? You want to go do standard public speaker training, 10, 20 lakh. But trust me when I say this is a whole nother level. If you want to upgrade this here was worth 2 crore that I paid. There's no video. I'm sorry. I'm not sure if I made myself clear. There's no video, yeah? Okay, you're so close. Again, we are watching his eyes like a hawk. And wherever he puts his eyes, will show if we trust him or not. Wherever he puts his eyes, will show if we're going to lean into him or not. And the moment that he puts his eyes somewhere that is not relevant, then he has lost us. Yeah? Hey, isn't he doing a great job? Let's give him a round of applause. Give him a round of applause. All right, we're going to do it again. You can do it. You can do it. Let's try it. Let's try it. Ready?
I live in Delhi.
Now, keep your hand in Delhi. Look at us. Look at us. Look at us. No, not yet. Watch this. Ready? You can't... No. Guys, by the way, I guarantee you, I don't care how trained you are, if you're up here on stage, it'll be just as difficult. It's easier said than done. I have paid 2 crore to learn this. You can't learn it in 3 seconds. It's a lot now. So the thing about it is, get this, what's really fascinating. You guys now sort of know the theory. You sort of now know the theory. But you do it, you do the prac, it's a whole nother level, which then means you can't learn in a classroom like this. You have to then invest in getting proper feedback from us, of course, isn't it?
Yes.
Great, let's try again. So again, you can't look at Sydney until such time as you say Sydney. So ready, watch this, ready, watch this. I live in Delhi, but where I really want to visit, I haven't moved my hands yet. I haven't moved my hands yet, but where I really want to visit is Sydney. See that? Let's try. Wait, just try that again. Remember, we have to go, I, that's an accent. Hey guys, by the way, there's 3 accents. What are the 3 accents? I, Delhi, Sydney. They're the 3 accents. You have to get accents right. Let's try again.
I live in Delhi.
Yep.
But I would like to Sydney.
No, close. Just slow it down a little bit, yeah? Delhi, but where I really want to visit is, by the way, get this ready. The longer you pause, the more intelligent you come across. Seriously, you've got to catch this, guys. You got to catch it. Let's try again. Just pause between each section. Let's try again. Shh, shh.
I live in Delhi, but I want to live in Sydney.
Give him a hand. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. Pretty good. Here, here. I've actually got one thing we do here is we love rewarding people that take action. This book here, I personally put in the hands of President Bill Clinton, Dalai Lama, Richard Branson. It's called Bounce Forward, How to Transform Crisis into Success. I'm going to give you this copy of mine.
Thank you so much.
All right, by the way, guys, we actually haven't finished yet. At the count of three, everyone stand up. Come on, everyone stand up. Everyone stand up. Everyone stand up. Stand up. Stand up. Okay, now, there are some trainers here in the room. Who in this room is a trainer? Come on, put your hand up nice and high. Yep, great, great. You're an LA pro trainer, come on, yeah, great. Hands down. So this question, which way is forward, which way is back? Which way is forward and which way is back? Come on, which way is forward, which way is back? No, that is incorrect. It is that way. No, it doesn't depend, it's always that way. Why? Because the clock turns this way and rewrites that way. Guys, last month's results were ridiculous, this month's is good, that's where we need to head. Guys, when I was a young teenage kid, when I was 10 years old, where we have been, this is where we are today, that is where we need to head. This is always the future, this is the present, this is the past. Guys, this is 101 presentation training. You won't learn that at Toastmasters. Guys, this is 101. Come on, you gotta learn this stuff. Wait a sec, I'll answer questions at the end and just trust me on this, right? So that is past, this is present, this is future. Now catch this, ready? Catch this. If I am your audience and you are my presenter, so you're influencing me, answer this question. Which way is forward? No, that is forward now. Come on. That is why, because it's not about you now. It's about me. You influence me. I'm seeing it by lens. Because for me, the clock is this way. And for me, right that way. It's not about you. Guys, like, catch this. Catch what I'm about to say. The essence of influence is looking through the lens of the listener. Wait a sec. Hear what I said again. Listen to this. The essence of influence is looking it through the lens of the listener. If you can start seeing it through the listener's eyes, you can influence anyone. So right now, you are my presenter. So for me, that is forward, because it's not about you now, it's about me. Which then means, I live here, Sam, because this is the present, it's past present, but where I really want to visit, because that is forward for you, Sam, where I really want to visit is that way. Am I making sense?
Yes.
Everyone's going to do this. We're just simply going to say Delhi and Sydney. That'll do, yeah? So I live in Delhi, but where I really want to visit is Sydney. Let's all try it. Ready? 1, 2, 3. I live in Delhi. Wait a sec. Delhi's this way. Delhi is here. Let's try again. Come on. See it through my lens. Let's go. Shh. Ready? 1, 2, 3. I live in Delhi. No, Delhi's this way. Let's just try it again. Ready? Yes, it's this way. It is this way. Delhi is here. Let's try again. Ready? One, two, three. I live in Delhi. Now keep your hand in Delhi. Now look at me. But where? Really? 1, 2, 3. But where I really want to visit is Sydney. Great. Now, this time what we're going to try with nothing at all comes out of our mouth. Completely nothing at all. So we're just going to do nonverbal. You know, one of the greatest ways to learn nonverbal intelligence is video yourself and watch yourself back with no audio. Game changer. Watch this. So everyone, nothing at all comes out of our mouth. Nothing, yeah? So we're just going to do the nonverbals. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Okay, again, nothing comes out of our mouth, yeah? Let's try it. Ready? Try it. 1, 2, 3. Great. Now, this time we've got to say a whole heap of gobbledygook to get the accents right. Again, with a three accent. There. It'll sound like this. Let's try it. I want to get the accents right. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Well done, give yourselves a round of applause. High five to the person next to you, give them a high five. Sit down. Wow.
Did you learn something this morning?
Aha moment.
Aha moment. I'm telling you, we haven't even gotten started yet. Maybe there is another level that you can learn from someone that has invested more than 2 crore on themselves. Maybe there is something that you can learn here. So let's bring your pride down and let's be... by the way, I just actually want to acknowledge many people here. Because I get it. There's so many trainers and coaches here. And there are people that are obviously are regularly teaching other people. But now all of a sudden, you are a student. And I actually wanted to thank you for being here and allowing yourself to be coached through today. Give yourselves a round of applause. I think it's awesome. It really is. Because it shows to you that you're not arrogant. It shows to you that you're still willing to learn. You're still willing to grow. And trust me when I say, I have my mentors and I have my coaches. I have them. Obviously, I do. But today, you are a student. You are not a trainer today. You're not a coach. You are a student, which then means I am your trainer. So let's get rid of the ego. Let's get rid of the pride, because this afternoon, we're going to take things to a whole nother level. And I need you in the right headspace for this. So be ready to take action when I ask you to take action. Be ready to come up on stage when I ask you to do that. And that way then you can be on this journey towards a student. Because trust me when I say that coaches and trainers, we need mentors and coaches more so. We do. I have my mentors and coaches, and you are here today for a reason and a purpose. So I want thank you and acknowledge you for that. Straight after lunch, guys, we're going to get straight into 3 of the most powerful in the market. This is a game changer, right? We do a lot of data, a lot of research on what's working, what's not working. I've got a team of like 70 staff members, and that's not including our trainers around the world, right? So we're a solid established company. But I'm going to share with you 3 of the most powerful words that are working in the marketplace right now. Just that alone is a game changer. I'm going to talk also about how you can really master video. I'm going to talk to you about the contamination whenever you are doing a presentation or a pitch, and sometimes that we're not even aware that we're actually contaminating the listener rather than disassociating it. I'm also going to be talking a little bit more about the 4 areas of nonverbal intelligence. So I'm going to really be unpacking a lot. And yes, the last 30 minutes, we're going to be talking more about how you guys can be a part of our boot camp, where I personally will be coaching you exactly the way I did up here on stage in order for you to what? Make more money, change your life, in order for you to close more deals, in order for you to really master exactly how you can be stand out from the noise and be a storyteller and a story shower. Who in this room wants to learn how to stand out from the noise? Come on, put your hands up. Great. So we're now going to have some lunch, and lunchtime is going to be between 1 and 1:45. So I want to start right on time at 1:45. Please do not be late. We will see you there. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Honestly, my dad signed me up for the session.
How'd you go?
He attended one of Sam's workshops. And as soon as he went for that, he said, Pooja, this is where you have to be. Death is inevitable. It's not something we want to face. For us, it's somewhere there in the distance. Sometimes you need a little bit of a push or a nudge to take yourself from good to great. And that's what I came to Sam's workshop. Make death your friend. Acknowledge it. It is difficult. It's not easy. But that
That's one thing I want to change about myself. I want to be able to speak in front of people confidently. So that's the reason I attended the bootcamp.
For as long we've been taught to work hard, save money. But in reality, saving doesn't make you wealthy. That is why I have found the FinDerm mindset, so that I can help you benefit to achieve financial freedom.
Public speaking event is more of how you can improve your communications and really connect with people on a mutual level.
Suresh, you're the you might sometimes feel that you're more of an introvert rather than extrovert. You see other people up there on stage, you see other people out there, and you've always been this back end person. That's not what I see. Someone like you is so solid that when you make a decision, you're not going to change your mind on it at all. And Suresh, we need more people like you in the world.
Research has shown that the people get into depression or helplessness state when they don't put these right questions to themselves. There are a lot of things that you have to got to learn. You have to got to inspire people. It's not just the content that you have to deliver to the people. It's about how you deliver. So that has inspired me. And I know that if I have to got to go out and live my dream of changing lives for the people, I have to got to learn the skills of story showing than storytelling. I know that I am 60 to 70% on storytelling, but I think story showing is what it will make a lot of difference to the message that I want to get into the world. The 3 days have not disappointed me, and now I think I have that in my muscle memory. Going forward, I'm going to use story showing to deliver my message. And Sam was very instrumental in taking step by step to make me to reach, and believe me that I can do it.
You are really easily coachable. You can see big things happening with you. You're relevant. And when you're relevant, you can actually then get people attracted. So continue to be the greatest version of yourself. I've just loved your transformation.
Believe me, words are powerful.
I was not at all in the mind frame to join the bootcamp, but I don't know how to market myself. Sabotage yourself, appreciate the person you see in the mirror. And that one line I didn't know will change me so much that within a week, I was able to prove myself. Bootcamp is a lot of energy, lot to learn, and the proximity that you are involved in. And you are with the best. That I have left of the person I was 3 days back, and today I am someone different, going ahead, really going to accomplish my dreams. The one key lesson that I would be addressing upon from now on will be showing my story. Showing my story in a way that people really get inspired.
You're an absolute powerhouse. You can't help but listen to you. You demand the attention of the room. You're so congruent. I can see it in your eyes. I can see it in your heart that you believe in every single word that you say.
Today I know my story is important, and story has everything. But it's just that I have to show it to them so that I'm able to inspire more lives around.
I would love to be a part of your journey in creating a one-man factory for your organization.
It's always been in the back of my mind, you know, as a business entrepreneur, as sort of a CEO, communication is really key. It's how you communicate the message. It's not really what you say, but how you say it. And that has always been something that I've been aspiring to be better at.
So let's join hands and do exactly that. Take your organization to the next level where it belongs.
What I learned is the bag of tools. It's like I feel like empowered. I have a bag of tools that I can bring out depending on the audience, depending on the context, depending on what the message is. There's always a better way to share the story, to communicate that message. And that's really kind of what I took out of the bootcamp.
I can see this message here being on a TED stage. You know, you really are a thought leader in this space. And not only that, you've got all the experience, you've got the heart and the passion to actually want to make a difference. This is a core message that you need to take to the world.
I came here to bootcamp because I was an aspiring public speaker. Do you want to be successful?
Yes!
Great, you are in the right place. Do you know what my teachers, mentors, and gurus call me? Mr. Smart, Mr. Success. I'm not bragging about myself. I'm ever more grounded than ever because of the responsibility. Success is a responsibility. That's how I see it. After coming here, what I learned was speaking is an art which can be learned over a period of time, and it's connected with emotions.
As an experienced Toastmaster, congratulations.
Thank you.
You know, one thing I really want to encourage you towards is there's nothing at all for you to prove. You've already achieved everything that you've achieved, which is just awesome. Continue on this journey towards what's possible for you being an influencer. I know that there's lots and lots of people that can learn and grow from you.
So when I go back from here, I'm going back as an influencer, thought leader, to influence the whole world.
I've been helping thousands of people over this past 12 years. But what I realize is that I have a deeper message to share with the world at large. To go to that world-class stage, I need to really fine-tune my skills much more. And in Sam, I saw that.
Did you enjoy your lunch?
Yes!
Awesome. Did you get your book story showing?
Yes!
Aren't we generous here?
Absolutely.
Yes. You give me a decision to be here, and we are more than happy to make sure that you do get some value from it. And so I'm really glad you came along. Are you glad you came along here today?
Yes!
Thank you. Do me a favour, turn to the person next to you and just say thanks for being the best looking person in the room. Come on, do that. Two, two, one, two, one, two, hey, 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 one, two, one, two. Ooh, yeah. One, two, one, two, one, two, hey, hey, one, two, two, one, two, one, two, great. Okay, what I would like for you to do right now, I want you to get out your phone, please. Come on, get out your phone. Seriously, get out your phone. Get out your phone for me. One thing that we do a lot is that we send out a lot of really valuable content on where the future is going in the area of influence. And so I want to stay in contact with you, which then means this. Find your Messenger app. Seriously, find your Messenger app. And then go into Messenger, and then go down below, which is click on people, and then inside people. Already we have Kamajit. Now you start to go to add people, and then scan code. See where it says scan code? You can actually scan what's either on every second seat. So on here, guys, I'll show you exactly what to do here. Ready? So you're gonna see that. Look. You're gonna see that, yeah? And then from there, I need you then to put that circle inside that little circle and then go get started. So already we have lovely Kuma. Welcome to the family. Welcome to the tribe, lovely Kuma. We have Kamajit. Hi to you too, Kamajit. We have Ruchi. Welcome to the tribe. Welcome to the family. It is great that you are a part of our community, part of our family. We have Sonia Gupta. Welcome, Sonia Gupta. Manish. Welcome, Manish. Chajabra. Welcome. Hamshika. Welcome, Himshika. It is great that you're a part of the community. Paral. Welcome. Ayender. Welcome. Lokesh. Welcome to the community. Welcome to the family. Rohit Sethi. Welcome. Rajesh. Welcome. Ayender. Welcome. Welcome to the community. Welcome to the family. Sandeep, welcome. Mintan, welcome to the community. Welcome to the family. Sandeep, welcome. Monica, welcome Monica to the community. Harsha, welcome Harsha. Sonia, welcome. We have Ruby Betty, welcome. We have Dishant Singh Power, welcome, and smiles to you too. We have Dishant, welcome. We have Harsha, welcome.
We have a lot of new people here joining our community. We have Ajay, Jane. We have Arimban. Welcome. Taresh, hi to you too. Sanjay, welcome to the community. Gitti, welcome to the community. Madhav, welcome to the community. Rajiv, welcome to the community. Welcome to the family. We have Swati, welcome to the community. We have Shilpai, welcome to the community. Meghna, welcome. Monica, welcome. Sharif, Rajiv, welcome, and smiles to you too. Asim, welcome. Madhav, welcome. Dipika, welcome. Dipika Jain, welcome. Sanjay Valid, welcome to the community. Welcome.